out there 3 weeks or 2 weeks. 3 weeks. I hate those people who do this, dude. We do it for the donations. Right? What you want to do is get the airway, like, just so a cock doesn't enter your mouth type shit. You understand? Try not to move your neck. Get fucked in your back. Just pouring water. Longer arms means longer range of motion. And YouTube channels are fucking cringe. Fitness YouTube, they don't know what they're doing. Finished my whole workout. Some volume for donations. That's it. Right? Yeah, take that picture, bro. Donate, you little fucking bitch. Don't just watch. I'm tired, okay? I'm really exhausted. DMX in this bitch, bro. I'm fucking DMX in this gym. Monkeypox? I already got my vaccine for it, bitch. Houses. I wear gloves. Invisible Stormcaster's gloves. Should I do a 3 month suck out tier trend? It doesn't matter, bro. Right? You're ugly whether you're on steroids or not. That's the truth. Why are you trying to be unhealthy and ugly? Right? Steroids are for good looking people. Yeah, that's not you, bro. You're just going to be a bigger, uglier version of yourself. Now watch. Are you watching? Stretch marks. See those? bitch. Don't play, bro. Don't play with me. Looking small. That's because you look at my old photos where I'm juiced. This is natty size, bro. This is huge for a natty. You want to see how big I am? Check this shit. I'll return. Hold on. I'll be back. Hold on. Okay, guess my weight, bro. Guess my weight. Zirka looking like that dude you avoid eye contact with? Bro, stop, man. I'm a nice guy, bro. I'm nice to everyone in this fucking pussy-ass gym. Cowards, bro. Just a bunch of cowards in here. Y'all a bunch of cowards. But yo, check my weight, bro. Check my... There's so many fighters in this gym, too. There's like a lot of MMA guys. They won't look me in the eye, bro. They know what's up. Look at this. With the phone. Ready? And the shoes. Look at that. Look, oh, man. It's because I sweat. I lost 3 pounds. I swear I was 260. I'm not lying. I was 259 something, but this is post-workout. Let me just... I got weight. Bro, come see me. 6'5", 250, 260, excuse you. Who said 250? Ban that bitch. 7 month ban for you, you little bitch. Don't you lie on my name, right? I dare any streamer to come fucking, I dare any streamer to come suck my dick, see if I don't suck it harder than they suck me, right? I got weight, come see me, bitch. I got weight. Let's go finish that workout. Pussy ass bitch. Never mind, there's a dude bigger than me there. Fuck. FML, bro. FML. I bet that high body fat percentage, though, it doesn't matter because I hit like a truck, bro. I'm not trying to look good when I knock you out, you little bitch. You little bitch. Your dad's small, too. Don't forget that. Your dad's a little bitch. Tech, I'm talking to you. Your dad's small as fuck. He gave you those garbage genetics. And you've been here for a while, so I know that hurts you, bro. I know. I got weight, bro. Come see me, bro. I got weight. Let's go. 1,000 reps. Fucking tired, bro. Fuck. Woo. See that? That's good. Two, I'm holding two big fucking cocks. But I'm in control. I'm in control. No neck movement. I'm in control. I'm in control, bitch. I'm in control. Tell me your dad can't do this, motherfucker. Your dad and that. He didn't mind it that much. He actually kind of liked it. We're done here, bro. You're a little bitch. All of you are quiet little bitches in the gym. Remember that. Stupid workout. That's like a shoulder snap workout. Yo, check this. Look at this, bro. Nah, I'm not doing this. Come on. It's cocaine cardio time, bro. Let's go. Mmm.
You're looking kind of thin, John. Are you sure you're eating enough?
That's because you're comparing me to my fucking competitive days, you fucking retard. Obviously, I'm going to look thin compared to my OG photos. Are you stupid? That shit was fucking... That shit was like 3 hours a day and actually fucking like 6-7 fucking meals. Oh shit, I'm going to look like skinny. Come stand next to me and see how skinny I look, bitch. Worry about your own genetics. Your garbage ass dog shit genetics from your ugly ass mom and your ugly ass dad. Ugly ass genetic. Genetically fucking... Your family genetically failed you, bro. Right? You look at your parents like, I love them. They're ugly, bro. That's the truth. Oh, you broke the machine, bro. Come on, bro. Ah, fuck, bro. My karma come quick, man. My karma come quick. Wow. I'm trying to do some cocaine cardio, bro. Fuck. All right, we'll cut the power. So thirsty, dude. VIP, anyone who stream snipes me and gives me a water bottle that's unopened. Like, I gotta hear that bitch pop. Right here. Right here. Up you go. No, don't snipe me, bro. I don't wanna see your fucking dog shit genetics, bro. You! Let's get it popping. Oh, got a game on in chat. Letting shit here. Cardio Confession. Who made that channel? Cardio Confession. Now we burn all of our calories off. By that I mean burn all of our gains off. Just to be more aerobic in case we need to fuck your mom. How's it be? I'm only 260 pounds, bro. I gotta be 290 to fight streamers. Special comedies. Cardio is the meditation of life. It's boring, but it must be done. It must be done. Gynocentric, bro. Shit, don't do that in public. Tall people don't weigh a lot, bro. I know 6'5 guys that are like barely 200, right? I just care a ton of upper body. Right? You know what I mean? I'm dying on pills. Okay, just gotta watch you, bro. Don't do this. I'm gonna be kicked out. It's not cardio, bro. We flying. I got weight, come see me, bro. Don't say it's not the ball of magic, bro. It's the circle magic. Titty. Look at these titties.
Zelensky! Zelensky, I'm coming for you! 40 billion dollar credit card while Americans are starving to death? Don't think so.
You see me, bro. You see me. No boxing map on the street. In a video game, GTA, whatever it is. Don't worry. Let's get the donations going, boys. I'm talking on a fucking phone in public for free. No more Zoom streams if I don't see a $100 donation right now. What about Mini? If you're on a bunch of steroids in here, you can accomplish anything without cardio. If you're natural, cardio makes more sense. Faster to hit your goals with more peace of mind and calories. Is it annoying, the sound? Should I change? Maybe I should change the machines here, or it's all the same thing. Fuck. What if I hold it? Does that make sound? I got way, come see me, bro. Parking lot shit. Yeah, now I have to hold the fucking phone, though. My shoulders are burning. Ow! Ow! So funny, man. I'm not used to being in public anymore. But I remember acting like a total little schoolgirl when I was bouncing, so people would choose to fight me. And then they'd be like, why is that guy sound like a little bitch? I'm like, hey guys. And then I would fucking out. I had anger issues, bro. And now I'm so, now I'm only angry at myself, man. You know? Turns out everything I hated, bro, was in the mirror. Like, that's some shit. What, wait, can you repeat that? Need what?
I don't know.
No. Wait, bro, I'm gonna go on steroids next year and compete. Nah. Wake, I wouldn't train with you. You're a white guy, so that means you train in the morning time. That's the one thing I don't like about white people. They do like early morning workouts, and I mean, it's good if you're fasted, but I don't know. There's something about me that, like, it's good on a Sunday maybe, but can't do that. Have you noticed, like, white people be waking up at 6 a.m. to work out? Like, who got time for that? Bro, I want to sleep. I love how I just left the white card. Like, I used to be white, and then I said, no, I'm a minority, bro. I just gave it up, bro. Can't go back. Don't want to go back. Afro-Latino in the house, bro. Let's go. Ask me what I identify as. Ask me what a woman is, bro. Don't know. Whatever they want to be, I guess. unless it's an engineer. I'm kidding, bro. I'm totally joking. Don't ban me, bro. I'm a comedian. Let's go, bro. Let's go. Tweaked. Let's up the speed to 3.1. Ooh. My mom once asked me, do you really hate women? No comment, mother. I got weight, come see me, bro. I saw my mom in the parking lot, bro, and she won. Are we effing? How long did it take to get your own? I don't have it on. I'm really long. But if you do chin-ups and dips, you can have some of the biggest arms you've ever owned in 6 months. And then and you gotta be eating, obviously, but after that, after your first 10, 15, 20 pounds you gain, you never gain weight again, really. Then it's just working on details and strength. So, like, if you've been training for years, you gotta understand that as a natty, you're done. That's it. Unless you're taking it really serious, like the 3DMJ crew, unless you're doing that, it's really gonna be like, you know, you have like that, that frame you're gonna work with for the rest of your life. That's why I recommend a coach for a lot of people. A coach is great. Well, no, I'm more doing athletic training than getting back into morphing. I don't think I can morph anymore. I can just look a little tighter, that's it. But I'm never gonna be like stacked as fuck like the good old days. I guess I'm stacked for like a regular person, but like, I don't know, I feel small compared to what I was. That's why you should never actually compete, because then you're forever small. You know what I mean? Or forever fat. Any baddies? I don't look, dude. I don't look. I am looking around, but I'm not looking at the ladies because, like, I'm 28, so to be in my cheater mode is kind of embarrassing at this age. And COVID robbed me of 2 years of cheater mode, but I could imagine really being embarrassed if I got exposed, you know? So I don't tempt myself. Because part of me does, though. Like, I never talked to the girls at the gym, but like the good old days, I can turn that on. But it's not good, dude. Chasing women is a waste of time, waste of life, waste of energy. I imagine that's what I'm good at. Isn't that sad? So one thing I don't want to be good at is I'm enlightened, motherfucker. Yeah, so fucking fat chicks is a great way to put on some muscle. That's no joke. And an almond a day type diet. One almond, get shredded, bro. It's got a lot of fats too. regulate hormones and shit. No, I think you cheat. Cheat on the girl till you're 25. 26 is cringe. 27 is mega cringe. And 28 is like, dude, what are you doing, bro? Like, I remember telling you guys, I'm like, guys, let's do these pickup streams quickly. Because when I'm 20, on my birthday, I'm going to be like one girl guy. And like, people don't believe me. So those streams are over, bro. No more Carlin's. I'm proud of that. Fourteen minutes, and an active rest type glow. Just a little sweat. No huffing and puffing. Not trying to go completely dead. Bro, I hate it, man. I hate a busy gym, bro. Dumbbell weights, not much. I think I benched, perfect form benched like 160. I did 8 reps today. I'm not really feeling that good from the last 5x5. So I'm like, I either skip today or go up a little higher in reps. And I was like, you know what? Let's go a little higher in reps. Let's clean up the form and let's just, you know, keep traumatizing this body a bit. And it was a good workout. Kind of weird because I had food in me from hours ago. And I don't know, there's no happiness in working out with food in you. Empty stomach and then gummy bears in the gym is like the best thing you could do. But I botched the mission today, which I'm gonna beat myself up about for like 2 days straight, and I'll be thinking about how I fucked this one up. But it's good. Oh yeah, I'm big on cardio, yeah. It's just, it keeps me more mechanical, you know? The lifts feel better, everything feels better. The heart feels better, the lungs. Plus I smoke cigarettes, so, you know, like I gotta be doing something. I just weighed myself 260. I sweat out 3 pounds, went down, but that's with a shit ton of food, sodium, water in me. So my real weight's probably 250. Because the way I see it is like there's two types of people: people who change when they eat, and people who, you know, it's maybe a 4 pound difference. I'm definitely those people that can skyrocket up. Like if I have a granola bar with my bench press, lift 50 more pounds easily. So for me, like, sugar is, I can fill up, but I don't stay full. I can only look full, like glycogen full, for maximum 2 hours. And not just working out, I mean anytime, it just starts to fade. Like, I'm not made for this sport. I can take photos that look good, but this, I got buddies who can stay full off like 2 meals all day, which is incredible. That is incredible genetics. And they don't even realize it. All they do is talk to me about height. And I'm like, bro, you don't even realize how muscular you are. So everyone wants something else, right? I'd want more thickness. Or not more, like my good old days. walking is barely cardio. No, don't be an idiot. Huffing and puffing is not good for gains. Right? If you're jogging, then you're killing gains. I mean, unless, if you're fat, you should be, yeah, you can do that. It's kind of bad on the joints. But I'm at a point where if I don't die slowly, I lose everything. I lose arm fullness, shoulders, I lose all my muscle if I do an aggressive cut. So I have to just slowly peel it off. Bit of cardio, slash calories here and there. This week is like a diet break. And then for June, I think I want to stay tight. I want to be really, really tight around, all around.
No, I can't eat. I can't eat for a long time now. I had a big meal today, which I don't normally do. And it would be best, but I actually, you know, I did that for years and I can't do it anymore. I can't do that thing where I like force food down. I can't do it at all. Like I'll easily wait 4-5 hours, which is horrible after work. It's not that bad. You know, it just matters. Macros is what matters weekly. Like when we look at the net weekly calories, that's all that matters. But it does feel weird to like deflate throughout the day with no calories. But No, dude. I think a lot of... here, I'm going to touch on a topic right now. Hold up. Okay. Hold on. Okay. Okay. Plane. 9/11 was bad. Right? When I see planes, I have traumatizing
memories. Not that I was a part of 9/11. I just, the first thing I saw as an immigrant was that on TV.
Anyways, what was I saying? The hell was I saying? What was I saying? How'd I lose my tan, bro? What the fuck? What was I saying, boys? Oh, right, about food. Right? Am I the only one here? Don't kick, bro. One in the chat if you're here. Yeah, I'm more of a GameCube guy. Am I the only one here, bro? What the fuck? Is anyone here? What the fuck, bro? Why do I feel like Simba? What's up with this delay, bro? What the... Okay. Here's what I'm saying, all right? Yes, it's important to, like, push food down, right? And do everything correct. However, a lot of people don't realize, and you're probably one of these people, you live a life of lethargy. You live life lethargic.
You come on, bro. I'm fucking doing a video.
You live a life where you're always dizzy, moody, sleepy, whatever the fuck. It's not worth gains if you're living like that. It's not worth
enough, man. Come on.
This is not a life, dude, right? To the gym guys, I've been you for years, and it's like feeling pukey, feeling like sleepy and having my sugar like this, that, this. Dude, at some point you gotta ask yourself, okay, I'm not winning a fucking trophy. What the hell am I doing? Is this all just to look 10% more, you know, better and shit? And no, I've been happier ever since I said, no, fuck that shit. I'm a live life first and be competitive second, because I spent my whole 20s like nauseous, and I regret that so much. Now I'll do anything to feel good, except cigarettes, but even that makes me nauseous. But yeah, now I'll do anything to like feel good. Yeah, progress while feeling good is real progress. It's not like that whole I'm pushing chicken down my throat all day. So, but when I was in competitive mode, that makes sense. You know, competition comes first, right? That makes sense. But then priorities, right? I don't know. Also kind of red pilling when I found out a lot of my hero fucking fitness icon heroes were not lethargic and dizzy. They were having fun, eating, working out. Like, I guess their bodies could handle that lifestyle better. But man, me trying to down all that protein was like, I did it. But damn, dude, there's so much of that life I can't believe how much of that life I did, dude. Imagine I put that money into like anything else. And that energy, I mean. Not money, energy. No. You're not meant to enjoy life. I'm not saying no hippie shit. But if you're not competing for a trophy with next to Canute, maybe don't be fucking 300 grams of protein a day. Don't go full retard like I did. Right? Because I kept doing it even when I stopped competing. Or thinking I was going to compete. And, man, all the parties I missed and everything. And you think like, oh, fuck, partying is like stupid. It is. But the brain doesn't just miss parties and they never happen. It tries to hypercompensate. So in 1 year, you go to 100 parties when you quit fitness and you fuck yourself up, like drinking and all this stupid shit. Like, I felt like, you know, you get FOMO or some shit. I should have just consistently gone to a few parties here and there and kept it moderate instead of been full bodybuilding mode and shit. But then, you know, my organs were asking for a fucking beating, bro. They were just asking for it. Yeah, a lot of shit I regret. I mean, I don't regret it because I got a good life. Or I got a good mindset. My life is, it's struggle. You know, there is struggle in my life because I was comparing to my, like, rich buddies that I chill with, and they don't work that hard. You know, they'll have, like, 6-hour days, but they're in good positions. And I'm like, dude, when I'm winning at life, I'm doing a lot of hours plus streaming and, like, 3 things at a time. And, yeah, not that I want to do less hours, but I want to get paid more for my hours, you know. Whatever. What are the questions? Bro, I'm not reading questions, bro. You guys are stupid shit. Don't live with regrets. Yeah, I'm trying, bro. Yeah, don't gotta max out. Yeah, no, I realized you go further in life when you're going for 80%. A lot of people are like 110% in whatever you do. That's burnout and that's quit. That's not good. That's me, right? When I scaled it to 80%, I got a lot more done in different avenues, not just one fitness fucking waste of time. But my dad said it's not a waste of time. My dad's like, think of it as your black belt, you know? You have to master something. I'm like, why? I wish I mastered something that brought income when I was in my, you know? I feel like I'm playing catch up. But yeah. Oh my God, look at these stretch marks. That's just ugly. Look at that. Yeah, they're everywhere. Watch me deflate, bro. Look at the pump just fade. This is the true ectomorph. Ugh. But I think that's why I look good at my peak bodybuilding days, because some ectos really peak nice. It's just to sustain that peak requires so much. But look at that. Everything faded, right? So my body's begging for food, and I can't eat. No way. Cannot eat, bro. I was thinking of food all day until I had this workout. Now I'm fucking done. The caffeine fucked me up. Ugh. Did he lift, chat? Damn, bro. Yeah, I did. Can't you tell? What's weird is in this skinny form, I can do way more damage. I can really, I don't gas out. I can, that's copium, bro. I'm small. Damn, I'm small, bro. I used to have like traps up to my neck and shit. Whoop. Yo, I was gonna ask you guys this. It's been years since like I've been wanting to ask this for years. Does anyone, when they're home alone, do like this? Do that stuff where you think of like some video game and you visualize it with your hands? Because I swear to God, bro, when people catch me doing this, it's so embarrassing. I got the house to myself, so I don't care. But today I was going crazy retarded, and I'm like, I'm glad I'm home alone, bro. Because when I get caught by like Eden or someone, they make fun of me so much, and I'm like, what is that? That's some ADHD. That's ever since Dragon Ball when I was like 8 years old. But it is autism. It's some weird shit, dude. It's just, oh my God, another plane. Oh my God, autism. Yeah, I'm over it. Let's go. I guess I got it from rappers, bro. You know rappers? We gotta do more outdoorsy shit, right? Like, no lie, I don't know if I'm gonna stream this, but look at this shit. I have a big Nerf gun that I'm gonna spray paint, and I don't know why, dude. Okay, so I was looking at astral plane, stonemasonry, and mystical conspiracy shit, right? And so I'm looking at all this stuff, and I'm researching about magic. You know magic, right? Humans have magic, then there's evil magic, and magic is just the will. Like, if you have a strong will, you're like Travis Scott, you can, you know what I mean? You can get people to sing your lyrics and shit. You can push your will out in the world through science, art, or usually both. Come on, bro. Come on. Enough plane shit, bro. Sponsored to you by Lufthansa. Get the fuck out of here, bro. Bless y'all. Have a safe flight. Bless y'all. Have a safe landing. All right? But anyways, I'm reading about magic, right? And it's been rebranded to like manifestation, all this cringe shit, but it really is like, you know, you put your will into the universe and, you know, you find a way, you know, like Canute saw what he wanted to be. He couldn't do it. He found steroids. He did it, right? You'll find a way, right? Anyways, that's besides the point, right? What was I saying? Right, so I'm reading about magic. What the fuck was I saying? Oh, right. Anyways, basically, it's like your artistic, creative self, when your mind is very plastic and neurogenesis is happening, you know, when you're a kid and puberty and all that, you don't want to lose that. That's why you have to keep practicing art. It's cringe, but you have to still be somewhat of an artist, somewhat of your own scientist, all that shit, right? And you must practice charisma too, right? To get people to do what you want, which now is called sales, I guess. But anyways, so I'm like, dude, I haven't done art. Something about Zirka is so pure. Damn, I'm gonna remember that. That is my second favorite comment. My favorite comment is Zirka has the most genuine laugh. I'm like, I thought it was sadistic. I remember you. I forgot your name already, but someone hearts in the chat for that guy. Appreciate you. I feel pure. But anyways, so I said, dude, okay, I'm doing my work. When I make money, I stop, take a break, then I go live, get my subs and get my team and, you know, keep building that internet resume, right? Alex Jones style, Joe Rogan style, all my life fusing with the internet, a little satanic, but we'll do it for a charity, the Zirka charity, just all into Church of Zirkology. Let's go, bro. Anyways, so I said, man, I haven't been doing art. I used to be a strong sketch kind of guy, artist, all that. So I said, dude, what's some kind of art that I can enjoy that requires very little skill and doesn't frustrate me? And I thought of graffiti, and which is so funny. When I was in Austin, I was on a date with this girl. We walked that bridge in Austin, and there was a guy doing graffiti for, on Valentine's Day, he was doing graffiti for his girlfriend. He put the name with the heart, and I walked right up to him, and I'm like, you know I'm a cop. And his heart fell through his asshole, and they froze on Valentine's Day. I'm like, I'm fucking with you. And I kept walking. And these three people who saw were fucking traumatized. It's like middle of the night. And yeah, so anyways, him doing graffiti, it stuck in my head. I'm like, I don't want to do graffiti. That shit's cringe. But I did buy a matte white, pure white spray can. And I said, dude, I have Nerf guns that I want to throw in the garbage, right? I'm going to just spray paint them. Maybe tiger camel, maybe whatever. If I want to do something nostalgic, I'll go with the tiger camel. If I want to do, so I'm like, first one I'm going to do is a base of white. And then I realized, dude, I don't need to do art. I just bought a bunch of spray cans and I'm just going to spray my old Nerf guns. I'm not gonna do black or anything that'll get me killed with my immigrant ass, right? Come on, bro. How many we got? You, hey, that's American Airlines. You guys fucking suck, man. Hey, man, you suck dick, bro. You suck dick. Ooh, a seagull. It's a nice seagull. Anyways, yo, so I bought a spray can and I want to do it on stream, but I realized this looks really illegal because I'm going to do it, like, where can I do it where I, you know, should I grab newspapers and shit? Like, where can I do it legally on Twitch, right? Because for some reason, every Twitch streamer can break the law except me. If I don't put a seatbelt on, they fucking, I'm done. It's over, right? But yeah, I'm gonna do that. And yeah, I got a few Nerf guns I want to spray paint, and I don't really know what I'm trying to like get out of this. It's just it's been almost a decade since I did anything like artsy, and I'm kind of nervous because like, what if I don't enjoy it? Then I have like, I wanna be like, I wanna have a like 20 minute hobby a day, you know? Like those people who build planes, like the little toy planes, or those guys who put the fucking boat in the bottle. Something about Zirka is so pure. I think I'm retarded, bro. What are you talking about? Pure my ass. There goes another plane. Ah, fucking up my stream. But yeah, I'm gonna do this spray paint, and I'm you know, I'm starting to realize how retarded this sounds, because like I was studying Freemasonry. I was like, yeah, bro, I'm sorry, man. There's some dude is watching me talk about this, but so the astral plane, enough, bro. Come on. I guess I'll show you what I mean. Oh, Jill in chat. Bro, that girl got a... I don't want to get banned. That girl got a nice body. She's very fit. No, that girl is the girl I marry, bro. You know why? Because I actually hate everyone else. I'm telling you, dude. This is the one person I don't get along with. But I get along enough to where I know they're end game, bro. That's it. That Jill is end game, bro. I know she's end game because, bro, I've met 1,000 females. If we count the club too, holy shit.
And dude, man,
I swear to God, they don't get me. Well, they get me, but it's like a fake thing, you know? I can tell in their heart they don't understand me. And in Jill's heart, she understands me. That's why I'm gonna spray paint her white, right? This looks like a white power ad. I'm no racist at all. I don't know what the fuck I was saying by that. I was thinking of the paint. This got really weird because I was like, you know, I just remember she's half Puerto Rican. This got really weird. You know, I was trying to say like, just painting section, not like anything racist. Okay, but anyway, so blanc, that's French, right? From Quebec. It's you know, XUC is Frenchy. There's two types of Canadians, aggressive ones like me and Quebecois XUCs. Why don't you just draw? That requires, you don't know me. If it takes a while for my hand to come back and I get frustrated. I don't want to be frustrated. I know this ain't going to frustrate me. This is going to be awesome, okay? Bro, what are you doing? I don't even know, bro. I got this. So I got this. And I'm going to be spray painting this all white. I don't know why all... it'll be the base. But am I supposed to put primer? Or I should probably dust this first. But, this, I forgot the magazine, so we're gonna have an orange mag, but we're gonna have this in all white. And if this goes well, I've got another one. I hope the electronic thing still works with it, because like I chased my nephew around with this, but it's gonna be all white. It's gonna look pretty sick, like a snow camo, you know what I mean? And hopefully this brings me some kind of happiness, this art project. I didn't even want to share this on stream because I'm like, you know, I'm always angry. I got to do something that's like something easy. You know, everything I do is fucking mentally hard. I want to do something that requires me to turn my head off. And then I go, I hope it satisfies me. You know, I just see the gun and I go, look, I painted that. And I don't want to do this. I don't know why I bought this. I must have been on drugs, bro, when I had this idea. It's matte white, non-reflective. I like that. Someone said in chat something about Zirka so pure. Dude, I don't know what I'm talking about right now, bro. I don't know where the... Where am I? Hey, another plate. Might as well dox myself, dude. I live at YVR. Come see me, bro. I got weight. Let's go. I got weight. Come see me, bro. Hey, you don't believe how much I weigh? I weighed myself in that gym. Go chat. What did it say? Electronic scale. And we lost 3 pounds from sweat. But what was the original weight plus the three? I'm gonna ban you, bro. Don't lie. Don't ever lie like that. At 257 post-workout, I was 260 even in that bitch. But I think that's with shoes. So, I don't know. Yeah, maybe 257 is fair. Yeah. I thought you lived downtown. I don't actually live in YVR. YVR is an airport, you fucking idiot. Also, I'm really aggressive. Don't step to me. If you see me, some guy saw me come out of a building and he looked like he wanted to ask me something. I just walk fast. Like, bro, don't talk to me. Just choof, choof. Anytime I do IRL, the Vancouver guys jump in. That's how I know they're stalkers. They don't ever watch me when I do other things. The simulation is looping planes. Bro, you're not funny, man. These simulation jokes need to stop. It's so fucking cringe. Every day I go live and I'm like trying to kick it with you guys, and then I realize I'm too cool. I wouldn't hang out with you in person, bro. You're not cool. Hey, you're like the stoner. Bro, it's the airplanes. It's like GTA simulation. So fucking embarrassing, bro. That
it's simulation.
It's just stop, dude. You're not funny. Oh, simulation theory. Oh, this is the last 5 years I've been talking about this. Oh, how the fuck is the sun still out? The earth is flat, bro. The sun don't go down. The sun moves far. There goes another plane in the goddamn simulation. Let's go. Let's grab some smokes, bro. Burr. Big burr. Yeah, so I don't know where to do this. If I did this in my bathtub, will I get in trouble? I haven't used spray paint in so long. This shit also terrifies me. Have you ever been maced before? I got maced by those Antifa cowards. And by, I don't think it was even intentional. He's trying to get my buddy. Well, probably me. I said, MAGA! And I was at work with my radio and shit. It was maced, that orange shit in the eyes. Like the bear one. Or I don't know what the orange one is. Dude, you'll believe in hell if you get maced. Like, dude, you'd rather be punched by Kimbo Slice than maced. You know, people are like, no, I'd rather be maced. No, you wouldn't. Like, you will believe, if you get maced, you will believe in God. Like, that's, there is a hell, bro. And hell is like getting maced. For real. See, someone said, imagine using mace, and he spelt it M-A-Z. And look, another plane in the simulation. Hey, Warlord Zirka, it's another plane in the simulation, dude. Oh my God. Yeah, where can I spray this without, like, someone getting mad? John on crack for real. Yeah, dude. No, here's what I was trying to say. Someone said there's no way you're 260 pounds because you move like a crackhead and shit. Like, you're too fast. I showed how much I weigh on the electronic thing. At 257, 260. But this is like after a meal, let's be honest. Like, I'm lying a bit because this is after a meal. That's not true weight. I'd say true weight to morning time, post peeing, right? Some of us hold, like if you're peeing a lot, right? If you're flushing a lot, your hormones are good, your estrogen's lower. If you're holding a lot of water, your estrogen's high, right? But yeah, after you pee, that's your true weight. Cause you can pee like fucking pounds, bro. But yeah, morning, post piss, post shit or whatever. Let's see if I got battery. 31%. I need a smoke, dude. Anyway, so I'm gonna do this art project, and worst case scenario, I have a white gun to play with. But if I enjoy it, I'm gonna start. I'm gonna start like making shit I enjoy, you know, like a lot of swords I want to buy online. I want to start spending a lot of money on swords and shit, right? I want to have like a hobby, dude. I realize I'm like a cranky old man. I read the news and get mad. Like I need to have something that's like not financial, not fitness, just something that's not a headache, right? And I'm gonna get swords, and I'm gonna collect swords. Like I used to have a bunch of katanas, and another plane in the simulation. Get out of your system, bitch. I'm not that huge.
Hello, I have this truck here. I would like to fuck a country girl from Abbotsford. I drive a truck, I fuck a white girl, and I love to go to the gym, and I like oatmeal and doing boring shit. Politically, I think the left and the right are too polarized, and definitely gotta look for something in the middle. I think the NASA space program was the greatest thing ever invented, and I've been a Caucasian male all my life.
Fucking white people, bro. So done with you guys, bro. Except the Australians. I see you, gold. Outermost gold in chat. Right? I tickle you. I like you. I like you a lot. Dear white people. Oh God, the other side. Don't get me started. Yo, make America great again. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Woo! I got weight. Come see me, bro. I got weight. Come see me. I look skinny. I'm big, bro. I'm dangerous. Two weapons, bro, right here, right? And one for your mama. I'm talking about my cock. She calls it a weapon. Not that I'd ever hurt your mother with it. She like it. Woo! Not this. I don't hit women. What the fuck? Speaking of hitting women, don't. What do we got? Heck, say something, bro. This parking lot's full too with gym goers. Another simulated plane. Oh my God. Why are Albanians so weak? Dude, every time someone in my chat comes and says, why are Italians so weak? Why are Chinese so weak? Why are Albanians so weak? The first thing I think of is your girl's getting fucked. She dumped you and she's getting fucked by whatever race you're mad at, right? I remember when I was a racist, it was because someone was fucking a girl I liked. And I think, you know, whatever race it was, I would be mad at the race. And then one day I realized, like, damn, bro, I don't want to be that chatter. Like, that's crazy, dude. That's crazy, dude. You don't want to be that. Like, God is watching. Don't do that. He's going balls deep in her, bro. No, dude, you know what's funny? I've never been cheated on, but now that I stream, now's the perfect time for a girl to cheat on me, right? Because then I get to go live. Guys, I have content today. Right? Like, could you imagine Zerka got cheated on the title?
That's just 10,000 views. They'd be like, the cocky guy, the guy that thinks he's fucking perfect. You know, now it's time to cheat on me, lady. Jill, it's time you go fuck some other dude. I'm kidding.
Don't do it.
How much you bench? Not a lot, dude. I'm not a strong guy with weights. Yeah, I'm not a strong guy. I was never even a strong guy at my best, you know? Take your shirt off.
Yeah, you want this?
Don't get me banned, you little bitch. You know what I miss is in my bodybuilding days, 4 weeks out of my contest when I looked perfect, I still didn't take my shirt off. And I was like, man, I'm not ready. And I was like, God damn, I look good back then. You know, I look really, that was like a 6'5" Z's. Z's was 6'2". So I was like, I wasn't even aesthetic or anything, like perfect symmetry. I was more just jacked and tank-like, and but it suited me, right? I had a young face, it suited me, right? And now I wish I did more fun shit back in those days, you know what I mean? So I don't look fine now. I feel like I look like a, I don't know, like when I go in public or the gym, I feel strong and I look good, but deep down my heart, you've ever been to your peak and you know you're not going there again because it's like unsafe or it doesn't make sense business-wise, you know, it's like a foggy brain to be at that peak. So it's kind of sad, you know. It's like if anyone's ever competed, you're like forever. Only Canute is happy on the off season, you know. Canute's really happy guy in the off season, but a lot of people, their brains get fucked. They're like, man, I used to look like this. I used to, you know, I used to like have delts coming out, like, yeah. At least you have broad shoulders and, oh yeah, true, true. Yeah, no, I read a study that what triggers a girl's arousal more than a man's fitness level is his shoulder-waist ratio. And they said, and I don't know if this is true, they said it triggers the same arousal as an hourglass shape for a guy when he sees a woman with that figure eight. And I'm like, bullshit, you know. For us, we get triggered way different than women. Right, like we're ready to go, but then they said, you know, when women are primed and comfortable and sweaty and they get triggered like men like that. I'm like, I don't know how much I believe that, right? But yeah, apparently that's like huge for women, which I never understood. I used to think it's like a big arm. All my life I thought a big arm is what girls like, which they do like it, but it doesn't compare to the height, wide and narrow stomach look, which we should all strive for. Just get taller, bro.
Yay!
And now they're playing in the simulated theory of simulation. Wow. Robustness. I don't know that word. That's the one word I don't know, but I believe you. Cheeks like ass, too. Eh. Dre Drexler, yeah. You know what's funny? The other day I felt so fake. I didn't stream, right? And I was like, I don't have a skincare routine and I'm 28. That's kind of stupid, right? So I'm just going to get a skincare product, right? I'm going to be a little, you know, I'm going to try and do something different this year, right? With my routine. And then I was like, I'm going to go find out what Dre Drexler uses because I don't know any other male beauty channel. And then I couldn't click on the channel because I was like, I'm so fake. Like, I roast this guy all day, but when I'm offline, I'm going to find out what products he uses. Like, I felt so fake, I didn't even go to the channel. And I'm like, you better tell chat how fake you were about to be. And yeah, I felt so fake. Like, I didn't go to the channel, so I'm like, I'll save it for when I'm live so people can at least roast my ass. We'll visit Drexler. I think Drexler is such a fascinating character because he's the perfect example, and nobody talks about this. Beautiful men are cringe. Studs are very cringe. Women don't realize how much they cringe with good-looking guys because they don't compare it to like a medium or ugly guy because they don't date them, right? Sometimes they don't. The ones that I'm talking about. And I'm thinking to myself like, oh my God, what did Mushi say about me? Mushi said, Zirka, this is like months and months ago when we were doing Royale, she said, Zirka is another plane, the simulated theory of simulation, bro. Good one. Mushi said, I'll never forget this. What'd she say? She said Zerka's the first good-looking guy, really good-looking guy, that is not, that is actually funny and not like cringe and weird. And you know, like 90% of the time, these studs don't know how to act. And I kept saying it and people were like, you're bullshitting. And then I found Drexler. And Drexler's the definition of like when the girls go in a room and feel powerful, like I'm the prophet of truth and whatever the fuck. And they're like making fun of a guy. They're making fun of the stud Drexler because he's just like, use my hair product to be like Jesus or whatever. Like he's almost based. But yeah, I'm like, that's why I'm so obsessed with it. Or I'm gay, one of the two. But he's not my type of... Oh, yo, dude, I never did this review. Who watched the new Halo? Dude, the new Halo. Mushi, I remember when you said that was fucking based. What, the new Halo? I watched it. Bro, I'm enjoying it. The elites were wrong, off model. The Prophet of Truth and Regret look good. $100 million budget bullshit, like where'd the money go? But I watched the new series on whatever platform it was, I forgot. The new Halo series that they spent so much money on. And Master Chief takes his helmet off, which is a big no-no, right? Chief is you. Whoever's playing the game, that's who Chief is. Right? It's not some white guy. It's not, you know what I mean? It's you. So even when the game, when he showed his eyes in 4 or 5, I forgot, I got really angry. I stopped following, right? But anyways, this guy takes his helmet off. Some 6'6 jack dude that plays the new Halo Chief, right? He plays the new John 117. He takes the helmet off, yeah? Dude, with all my buddies watching, I said, what the fuck? And my buddies don't talk when we watch movies or TV shows together because they expect me to do like the reacting, the funny shit. But I couldn't even react. I was so triggered when I saw his ugly ass, no lips. Like they went full fucking retard on this shit. And he took his helmet off and I'm like, what the fuck? And he looks like a fusion of like Zelensky and Adam Sandler as Master Chief. $100 million budget and that's the best they got, and he keeps taking his helmet off. He won't put it back on, not even for battle. So I'm traumatized and my buddies are kind of mad because they're like, John's about to ruin it. We like when you joke, but you're joking too much. They're trying to tell me to stop, my older brother's friends, and they're like, all right dude, you're being a little much, because I got really angry. And they're trying to enjoy because they paid for it, whatever. Now they're playing the simulation. So anyways, if you watch this, bro, you will never be angrier than this. The only one who looks like a Spartan is the black guy. I forgot. I think he has the blue Mjolnir armor. And he's got big veins right here. Super jacked. His face looks fucking like jacked too. He looks like perfect. He looks exactly what I imagined a Spartan looked like when I was like reading about Reach and shit. He looked perfect. I forgot who it is. Right? But Chief is the, oh my God, he is the most, it is the worst actor to play Master Chief. And dude, wait till you hear the voice. If you haven't watched it yet, wait till you hear the voice. Wait, here's Master Chief.
Not yet.
Something like that, right? This guy sounds like, it's like the fucking worst. The voice was everything for Chief. It was so... And dude, there's people who copy other people's voices. They could have easily fixed that, right? Like those old Enter the Dragon, like the mouth moves and they synchronize it shit. They could have done something. It is the worst fucking Master Chief I've ever seen. Anyways, I'm like, yo, skip the filler, right? We get it. It's another storyline of a daddy-daughter role, like the movie Logan, the spaghetti western shit. Which is a good movie, you know, but, or Joel and Ellie, which is a beautiful, I love Last of Us. Someone said I look like Joel the other day with the plaid. I was like, oh yeah, I do, bro. Like Joel's a big, masculine, fucking beautiful guy, right? Anyways, so this is the first time in my life I said, I look more like Master Chief than whoever's playing him. And I do. I'm John 117. Right? He has what I have, luck. I had luck, a bit of it, right? And
don't know, if you grew up with Halo, this is a gut punch, but all the fans are, oh, I'm so happy, content. No, man, no. This is, like, depressing as fuck. Anyways, because the real Halo is like, we got enough problems without you two trying to kill each other. Were it so easy. That's poetry, motherfucker. That's fucking poetry. Like, Halo 2 was, like, perfect, but Halo 3 was poetic, man. Right, with the Arbiter and shit. But this is garbage, bro. This is, like, obviously, I'd still recommend you watch it. Skip the filler. They go to the last scene, and I forgot if it was a brood. Oh, my God, another plane in the simulation. They go, so we skip to the last scenes, the battle scenes, and it's, like, it's one of those, like, Marvel Cinematic Universe, pow, and the blood is in the helmet's face and shit like that. Whatever. And there's these awkward scenes where it shows the camera inside the helmet. So you just see, like, a white guy, all panicky, and that's Master Chief. You'll know when you see it, bro. Come on. So it's super, super cringe. Like, I'll watch some scenes with you guys tonight, right? But, I forgot, was it Tartarus, or I forget the name, but, or maybe it was like a brood or something. Anyways, the final boss drops down from the Covenant's Phantoms, right? The Phantoms come, and then he just drops down with a hammer, right? And this movie got $100 million fucking dollar budget, and he drops down, boom, right, with the grav hammer or whatever the fuck he had. And we're all like, oh shit, finally, oh my God, right? We're so excited. And then the budget runs out, Project Blue Beam just shoots down and he starts floating up. Shoop! And they're like, okay, live to fight another day. And then they just go fuck off in the Pelican or whatever. And none of my homeboys got mad at that scene. And I'm like, dude, did you see what the fuck just happened? Did you see what the fuck just happened? Like, the biggest CGI dropped, and then they just, within 2 seconds, they just, we can't afford this fight scene. None of my buddies caught that. Then I said, dude, this show's a fucking scam. Let's be honest. Like, we paid $10 for this shit or whatever it was. And for I forgot what platform it is. I thought you guys are nerds. Nobody even knows what the fuck I'm talking about. But yeah, libs did ruin fucking Halo. Fuck that shit. And oh shit, there's people working. We better leave, bro. This is getting too loud. Yeah. Is it Paramount Plus? What do you get with that? Do you get anything else? That's the only thing I haven't seen is I think I saw the last episode. I don't know. Today, dude, I have like 3 hours to myself where I need these hours. And I'm like, I'm not going to work. Let's have 3 hours because I'm feeling angry. Let's just have 3 hours to myself. I started watching anime Jesus. And it was not bad. Like, I kind of want to watch it with you guys. Like, there's this anime of the Bible on YouTube, and I was so angry when Eve fucked up and ate from the garden. I was thinking what you guys would have said. And but yeah, I was watching that a bit today for like an hour, and then I came to the gym because I was like, fuck it. Gears of War movie. You know what's funny is, it's like a medium meme, which I thought it would be a mega meme. Rich Piana looks just like Marcus Fenix. Like, dude, it would have been perfect if the late, great Rich, rest in paradise, if he played Marcus. Would have been perfect, you know? And Gears of War, the first one, is one of the most underrated games of all time, and game styles. This is a game I played on stream, right? Dude, a third-person shooter is, for some reason, more fun than a first-person. A first-person feels like I'm shooting mosquito bites and, you know, it just feels weird. But third-person games, that's kind of why I like Guns the Duel or even Fortnite a bit. But another plane in the simulation. What I want to see a popular Gears-style game with that kind of engine. That would be great. Because you and your buddies taking cover, it just looks better. It just looks better to me. Gears was awesome. I don't know why the online's not that popular. It's dead. Yeah, Guns of Duel was my favorite skill-based game ever made. And
I forgot who. Only me and... I shouldn't do that, man. That's a living creature. I didn't hit it, but... I'm trying to be more Buddha. Except that Eastern shit get easily conquered. I'm kidding. Hold on. No, I'm trying to be more peaceful. Yeah. So anyways, the new Halo sucks. I don't know why we're talking about that. How'd we get here? Dude, I'm so weird. I'm so flattered from that chatter saying, "Junk, there's something so pure about Zirka." That is right here. Because if you knew the offline me, you'd say there's something evil about this man. Right? Like the offline me looks at you while you're crying and goes, "Dry your tears, you pathetic piece of shit." No, I don't do that. it's a little much. I just want to just go sit on there. Finally, I do some outdoors shit this summer. I'm not letting... Remember last summer, I didn't go out one day. Only at 3 a.m., like middle of the night. But I didn't go out one day. Like, not one day. And I made a ton of money, but... Yeah, that was the first time I, like, lost everything. All my friends, everything. And then I'm like, man, maybe I can move. Like, I don't do the same shit my friends do anymore and shit. I rarely see them. And yeah, like... This summer I'm gonna enjoy a bit here, a bit everywhere. But yeah, so good to get sun for once, man. Or see some sun. I got a bit of it. Let me get you guys all set. Oof. Oh, I got nothing. In a tripod, bro.
Oh, my asshole.
Fuck, dude, I can't get that. Don't sell more train tracks. It's closed. It says right there on the sign. This train doesn't come anymore. It's closed. Oh shit, this looks like I'm killing myself, bro. The train is closed, I promise you, but I just realized optics wise, that looks really stupid. Yeah, let's not do that. Let's go back to, should I put the phone on the garbage can? Is that disgusting? Yeah, that looked like talking about some heavy shit waiting for... You know, I could... It would be so funny if this train wasn't closed. And... Because if the train started choo-chooing behind me, that's a ban. Oh, I would be banned. But it says right here. It's like... That's why the grass grew on the track. Anyways. Okay, this looks like I'm a crackhead. Hold on, let's return... Back from whence we came. But yeah, dude, I feel like I got some fresh air today, you know? I haven't smoked a cigarette in 48 hours. I'm about to, though. Oh, yeah. So I'm going to get that with you guys. And, man, I got to take my batteries with me. More IRLs now that the weather's better. It does rain here a lot. So don't get mad if I lie a bit and don't always IRL. Fallout character. I never played Fallout because I'm not like, I'm kind of straight. You know what I mean? Are any more trains? I mean planes? Take a dab. Oh yeah, dude, we could grab weed today. Like, I haven't smoked weed in like 4 months, but you know, the weather's good. We can go wherever. Something's weird about this place where it's like, we have good weed, but it's like hard to find now. The worst weed I've ever tried in my life was LA. I was like, everyone was blasted around me, and I'm like, I'm not high, like, at all, right? And they were so embarrassed. All my Cali friends were like, try another hit. And I'm like, no, I'm used to BC Kush, man. This is just, yeah, this is weak, man. Like, LA weed is the most overrated trash. Only thing worse is Texas, right? I've never had strong LA weed. I've had okay White Widow. I've had, I don't know. No. Anytime I've, or wherever, I think the strongest weed I've ever had in my life was Bubba Kush. I don't know where that's from. Bubba Kush had me out. Like, I left my sales job. I just didn't tell anyone, just left work. Everyone's like, what happened? Is he sick? And I was like, dude, I'm hearing symphonies. Like, smoke weed in the parking lot. I thought I could be a salesman still, and I couldn't do it. I was having full-blown, I was hearing symphonies for hours. That was way too much. But yeah, there's some white kid who's like a mediocre rapper in my city. He gave me that shit. I like Surrey, bud. Yeah, anytime I smoke up in Surrey is good. Tap house, tap in. Afghan Kush, don't they have hash? That's what my Afghani buddy's like. But yeah, we can do whatever. And then we go stream from the PC and yeah. Fruit roll-ups, dude, it's kind of cancer, man. Like, if I'm gonna do candy, I'm gonna do sour keys or Airheads. But it is, yeah, a lot of that artificial shit is, you know, I'm an adult, bro. I should be avoiding that. Why are you outside? You wanna go in the whip? It's just I start effing when I drive around. You seem like you're on something. I think I'm just cold because in the gym I was acting normal. Now I'm tweaking. Do I look high? No. Interview? What the fuck? I'm trying to get away from people. Thoughts on XUC Gamba? I hope he keeps doing it every day of his life. Yes, I hope he gets everything that they're offering. And I mean, he's at a position where he doesn't really need to do it, but it doesn't really make sense. But no ill will to a working man. This is not the social justice channel, bitch. Another thing, yo, I want to talk about addiction, okay? All right. Look, obviously being addicted to gambling is bad, but people who watch XUC, aren't they already addicted to being, how do I say this without sounding like an asshole? Yeah, there's no way. You know what I mean? Like, what, we gotta stop pretending cigarettes, gambling, and hookers are the only addictions. Right? Because then you're just coming after me. But isn't, you know, being a Redditor an addiction? Like, every day you're on Reddit and you have no life, you just stay on Reddit all day, right? Isn't that, how's that not an addiction?
right? And an addiction really means it's damaging your life, right? Like, if you're addicted to something that's not damaging your life, then that's a good thing. So being a fucking, you know, like, whatever I used to be, right? Being that is already an addiction. It's not like if these kids... It's not like gambling is going to ruin these kids, okay? If you watch Twitch all day and you're a Redditor and shit, and you're an adult, you got to be like... some. My viewers will have two screens, right? They'll either be work and then me on the next stream, or, you know, they'll be... you know what I mean? But my mind's a little different. I don't really game and shit. But yeah, yeah, I don't think it's... You know, as a streamer, you're not supposed to say this, right? But it's not good to spend 10 hours a day being a watcher of someone. No, they're playing. Look, that's not good, man. That's not good at all, right? It's good when I'm teaching you something, but I'm not always teaching, bitch. Right? Sometimes you gotta turn me off. So... sometimes I think if gambling didn't exist, wouldn't the despair, XQC viewers, or Twitch viewers, not XQC viewers, Twitch viewers, wouldn't that despair lifestyle they're in, what would change if gambling didn't exist, right? Maybe it's just adding another vice to them if they get addicted, but what would really change? You know, like, they've got a deeper issue, because, yeah, yeah, not all, but most. So yeah, I think the only people who should watch XQC 8 hours a day are people who are going to be streamers, people who want to do that, what he's doing, right? When I was in fitness, I would watch bodybuilders 8 hours a day. When I was into streaming, I still didn't watch streamers. I tried to learn everyone, and then I realized, oh, I'm not a gamer. You know, I stream because I'm me, right? So I'm like, if I watch other people, it kind of like dilutes me, you know? Being me is like way better than me forcing some Gears of War stream, which was fun. And my last Gears of War stream was 1,000 viewers, which is mind-boggling now that I think about it. Mind-boggling. Like, what a lifestyle. To game and...
yeah.
But also, something weird happens when you game all the time, dude. 8 months pass by, and you wasted 8 months. So, the good thing about IRL streaming is, like, it feels like a lot of shit happened this year, you know? Because it was, like, LA and Austin and Mexico and, you know, a lot of shit. This year is already complete for me. Like, I've done enough. So, it's only getting better. And it's the opposite of last year where I just sat in a room. But last year, we were at 7,000 subscribers for, like, a long time. Like, more than half a year. Like, that was... I'm not even counting. The donos is what changed the game. Like, those donos were... Yeah, I stopped working to stream more. I was like, whoa, what the fuck? This is a little crazy. But, yeah. Kind of took my soul from me last year. But better position now, and... now I want to do Hawaii because I don't know if I want to do this summer in Canada because I'm 28. This is probably the last summer to, like, go hard at. So I'm thinking of doing June 1st, a few Vegas nights, and then straight to Hawaii for 10 days and IRL it. Not resort it, just IRL it. Yeah, I think that's a good plan. I got battery or not? 15%, okay. Let's move. You only need 100 loyal supporters and that's it. No, that's retarded, dude. If streaming is the only thing you do, you're retarded. You must be retarded. Streaming should be the focus. The internet is the future. No doubt about that. Right. Also, I know a lot of ways I can get more viewers and stuff that are really, really bad for my mental. So I'm like, you know what? Go back to the old fashioned way, dude. Okay, I have to be perfect. Before the keys go, I'm gonna drop you guys here. Can't see you. I'll spray paint this some other time, man. I already lost the fucking fire for that. See, when I was a kid, I'd be excited for this shit. Now I have to, like, force myself. Okay, I'm gonna see you guys at the gas station, right? Cannot look at you guys anymore. Thank you, man. Appreciate that, bud. Come on, bro. Handicap only. Come on, dog. You gotta be fucking shitting me. Excuse me. How much is it?
26.
It's because of Ukraine and Russia, bro. All right. Let's go somewhere else. Cigarettes and tiny liquor bottles. I love those Balenciaga sneakers. My brother trying to knock me out because I want to buy a couple of pairs. And I'm like, bro, they're the same price as the Jordans I used to like fucking drool over. Like, what the fuck? And he's like, bro, you're being cringe. And I'm like, dude, come on, man. And he's like, you're spending too much. You need to chill the fuck out. Because I can't buy shit without, like, showing a few friends and shit. Just so I know I'm not being a retard. Let's go. I'm talking to myself, bro. This is weird, man. I need roadhead. I need people in the world who want to live like me, you know? Jordy, one day the chickens are going to come home to roost. Yeah. Yeah. The fucking gas station nowhere to be found, blood. Okay, blood. Okay, blood. He says, because of Ukrainsky and Ruski. Fucking white people, man. Dear white people. Dear white people. My name is John Zerka. And... oh, shit. Maybe I shouldn't have conversations with myself about this. Yeah. I haven't thought of sex all day. What's wrong with me, bro? Oh, now I'm thinking of it. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh man, now I want some. Shit. Oh, now it's dominating my mind. And yeah, faster, Canute. Faster.
Faster, Canute.
Skirt, 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 skirt. Kelly Price, that's the theme song. Bro, chill the fuck up, bro. Chill the fuck up. Don't, not today, blood. Not today. Not today. Don't compete with me, bro. Don't ever compete with me. I got this motherfucker supercharged. They call me supersonic speed. Uh-uh. 15% bad. What's that on streaming time? 8? 15 minutes? Ugh. Come on, bro. Yeah, hit that button, you little bitch. Kidding, there's no one there that I didn't say that to anyone. There's no one there. I'm not a fucking terrorist. Cigarettes and big cocks in my mouth is what you get. Some smokies for the broskies, the ones that know me type shit. Got hoes in every city, except I don't. I remember having hoes and I'm like, okay, am I cool now? A waste of time. Swear to God, man, all you need is some hentai, your hand, and the calluses from stroking your dick to a fucking... It's not weeboo shit. Weeboo's not hentai. Weeboo is like some fucking 8-year-old anime girl pillow. That shit's pedophile shit. If you like anime young girls, you're a goddamn pedophile. And in a video game... Oh my god, what the fuck, bro? I'm not finishing this sentence. You're a goddamn weirdo. People think, for all my life, people made fun of me on Twitch because they're like, oh, he liked, when you were younger, you liked hentai. Hentai is like a big titty girl, bro. It's not a fucking child. On Twitch, hentai means like a fucking 8-year-old. These weeboos bugging, dude. Nah. Nah. We like women. If you don't got your nails done, you are not it. Automatically on the block list. Block, bitch! We like women. Right? We like women. I like women. I like Jilly Bear. I like Jillian. Jillian is my favorite human being on earth. Right? What the fuck is everyone in this fucking gas station for, bro? I don't give a fuck, man. Yo, make room. Are you almost done, bro? There's like 30 people here. Ha, fucking with you, bro. Have a good one. Yeah, look at me fucking crazy and shit. He gonna beat the shit out of me. That guy's 10 times bigger than me. Right? Oh, look at mommy over here. Hello, mommy. What's she looking at? With your 50-year-old ass. I knocked the dust off it. I'm kidding. All right. Let's turn this car off. Oh, there you go. Almost forgot. We need. Okay, now I can look at the phone. The car is off. Does he always talk like this? I don't know. When I'm feeling myself. What the fuck? No! No! Oh. Oh, bro, in the shadows, I couldn't see the black bag. Oh, bro, I thought I lost my goddamn passport here. Oh, bro, that's a sketch thing to lose shit at, bro. Why is everyone getting gas? 9 p.m. Everyone is. Wow. You'd think it'd be cheaper at night with all these people. Okay, just look at me, bro. Don't respond. Just look at me. Okay, I'm gonna bring chat with me. If I can't have friends. I got a Nerf gun. What the fuck was that? Okay. Cool. That's a Zelensky cigarettes, bro. Hello. Can I grab a pack of Belmonts?
King size already.
King size. I'm feeling like a king. Yeah. Oh fuck, is that me? I'm not used to this. More IRLs, guys? Subscribe so I know. I only stop because nobody, I feel like nobody fucks with them as much. But I know they're good. I don't want to be outside. I don't know they're good. I just make that up. No! They're good. Don't move. Okay, before this runs out, I hate the new packs, man. Oh, in Canada, we got different types of smokes than you guys. What do you smoke in the US again? Pall Mall? Oh, we have Pall Mall. What do you guys have? You guys do Marlboro or whatever? Nobody knows what a Belmont is? Or for the Frenchies, De Maurier. Distinct De Maurier. Wait, what? Good content, but I am a college student, no gift money. Dude, you've got a long time subscriber badge. I don't really expect it from you. Like, subscribing is good. Most of my gifters don't really watch me. They kick it with me offline a bit. And they hear some offline takes that are mind shattering. The Earth's a triangle, bro. I'm studying right now about the astral plane. with my YouTube degree, bro. Oh, bro, I don't fit, bro, I don't fit. I don't fit in the world, man.
Can you believe that? The gas price.
Or just look at me then. Just look at me like I'm some fucking... I'm talking about the gas price, bro. Come on. You do my content for me, bro. You don't got your nails done. You are not here.
Bro, I like that fucking... I like what you did with that exhaust, right? It makes it sound like you got an expensive car. You don't.
My favorite car, my brand new Impala, right? I'm not even a Chevy guy. Totaled it. Then I had a brand new Dodge Charger. Totaled it. And I said, you know, I want more visibility. I don't recommend Range Rovers. I called my dad crying, right? Through the second range. I said, yo, dad, can I sell it to you? He's like, what's wrong with it? I'm like, let me sell it to you, bro. He's like, what's wrong with it? I'm like, well, you just got to pay $40,000 to... That's... Or else it doesn't work. My dad's like, it's new. And I'm like, you know, it's been 8 months. Don't buy a Range, dude. You know, and I'm stuck because I can only get big cars or else I'm really depressed. I can't have toys. Like, I know everyone in my chat hates Mustangs. I'd be happy with a Mustang if I could fit in one. I can't, dude, my Range Rovers are tight. I like Mustangs. There's cringe people drive them, but I would change the game. You know? Super affordable too. Like, oh, what I would do to a Mustang, bro. So funny that there's one right there with the racing stripes. Ooh. But yeah, you guys are saying truck, but the thing is, I wouldn't use it. You know? That's why when I live in Texas, I think I'm gonna get well, then I can dirt bike, so then I probably need a truck. Although one person in my chat said, you're 28 years old and you didn't know you can just get a what's that thing called that connects to the back of the car, a mini storage trailer to put the dirt bikes in. And I'm like, why have I never thought of that? Right? I've never thought of that all my life. People are like, yeah, you need a truck. You need... No, you don't. Whatever it's called, the hitch. And but I don't have friends to dirt bike with. You know, my friends are like club rats. You know, if I told them we're waking up early to go here, they'd be like, yo, do a line of coke and shut the fuck up. And I'm like, I don't want to do that, man. I want to do something else. You guys are fucking junkies, bro. Leave me alone. Try and get it together. Drugs only on vacation, guys. I'm kidding. But yeah, dude, I'm thinking to myself, like, how much happier can a human be than dirt biking? Not really. You can't. There's nothing more. What's more? What is more than dirt biking? You can't get happier than that. What? Go see a movie? That's like... You know what I mean? And why I never did it, because I'm like, I'm not going to get paid to fucking... Yeah. All right, bro, we get it, bro. Can you believe that guy? No, never mind. This girl's 15 years old. Yeah, I'm thinking like a motorcycle. No way. My older brother had one. And dude, if you ride a motorcycle... And you're a city boy,
you are the lowest IQ life form on Earth. You are at the lowest of the low. I know how to ride, John. Dude, you could be the Schumacher, but on a bike. And someone's gonna come kill you. All right? Hell no. Nah. No, dude, every time I see bikers, I go, you waiting for someone to have a sleepy day and kill you? Like, are you really that person? Don't litter. Keep this. Man, I wish I had more battery, dude. I want to keep this going. Where am I? You know, I spent $700 on battery banks and I can't find one. Where are they? I had 5 for Samsung and then I switched to iPhone and I'm like, oh fuck. And I got 5 more and I can't find any of them. And I don't lose anything except that stuff. I have everything else, but geez, man. You know, and you know when you like know you're not supposed to buy them, you're supposed to find them somewhere in your place. So, yeah. Oh, we got one new one at the mall, yeah. Yeah, I forgot about that. And we have that case, the electric case, or whatever. No, not a car meetup. It's this part of town is like where all the rich people live, and they do. Like, I'm not even hating. All they do is get their parents' money and flex their nice cars and go to bubble tea and restaurants with their girlfriends. And then they become 30, 40 years old with no job, but they become like these zombies with no confidence, but with a nice car. It's really weird to see because, like, they're very timid people, they're quiet, they're, you know. So that's when I realized, you know, life is about achieving, earning stuff. Because how many people, bro, shut the fuck up, bro, enough. How many people do you know that are like born into like wealth and then they're like the cringiest person in high school, right? Dude, my parents didn't have money. Do you know when my parents made money? When I turned 20 years old. And I almost cried. I'm like, I went through all of high school broke or like middle. And yeah. And dude, I thought I was a good guy because I'm like, you know, I've let my parents help me a bit here and there. They used to take me to Europe and they travel a lot. And so I'd go on trips with them when I was younger, but when I was 20 and shit. But I never asked for a dime, right? And it was the biggest. If you're an immigrant, bro, and you think like me, where you're like, I'm not gonna ask for a dime from my parents because, like, I respect them, they're gonna give a lot of money to your cousins, uncles, family, friends, right? And every time I talk to my immigrant homies, they have the same story. And I'm like, oh my God, I wish I was more selfish. Like, you know, like my dad will look me in the eye and be like, I'll help you when you achieve this, when you achieve that, when you show me this. And I'm like, dude, my cousins be smoking weed and you're giving them that much? But then my dad will always say, he's like, do you want to be like your cousins? I was like, no, not really. But that shit bothers me, man. You know, that's all you do. If you're an immigrant, you take your parents' money, bro. You swipe that credit card, you know, you got to do that shit. You know what I mean? Because one day your parents will just be like, oh yeah, I got this guy a car. It's like, who the fuck is he? Well, no, he's going through a lot right now. And no, bro. Be more selfish with your parents' money, guys. Okay? Don't be filled with regret like me. You know, it's at 28. At 28, if I was to ask my dad for a dime, he'd laugh. But at 20, I think I could have done it. I think I could have gone away with it. I'm like, yo, I need $10,000, right? And just get a bunch of eight balls with the boys. And I'm kidding. But am I kidding? What am I? Probably. Yeah, so, I don't know. I don't know how much this battery's gonna go for. That's why I'm, like, cramming in everything. But, I like my rant streams, you know? Because the one thing I hate is tuning to a stream where you have to wait for the streamer to talk. But that's a good streamer. Like, stalling is effective, right? It's just I get bored. So this is the best stream you guys have had all week. This one right here. I do have a charger. I just didn't think I'd stream today. Like, I would never even stream a gym workout because it's distracting. So I always stream the tail of the workout. Last bit. Don't make fun of my intros, bro. Right? Because you hit live and then you go, oh, I'm excited. I'm going live. I better take a shit. Right? You know what's weird? You're always excited to go live and then you're like, why was I excited? This shit sucks. You gotta take a shit, bro. Meal? I can't do a meal, dude. Especially not after a cigarette. Ugh. And which sucks because I'm supposed to get calories in this week because I go back into a deficit. And for me, a slight deficit is like, bro, I'm starving. So, yeah. But that was the craziest shit I ever did this year is completely dropped a bunch of weight pretty quickly. And protein shakes. Yeah, I should slam a shake. If I slam a shake, I won't eat for another 48 hours. Like, that'll fill me up. Bro, open the... Dude, we're at a gas station. This isn't like a car meetup. What engines are you trying to hear? There's an Audi R8 there. Which, man, when the Audi R8 came out, it was the most beautiful supercar ever. But, man, Audi has this thing where the design kept getting watered down and... Dude, nothing I hate more than the most beautiful Lambo, in my opinion, that everyone doesn't like is the Gallardo. Not the Super Leggera where the lights get smaller, whatever the fuck. The 2004, the original Gallardo, right? The small, compact Gallardo, a little square, but I liked it. And if you look at what the Gallardo became and then the Huracan, it got very cringy. Right? And the same with the Audi R8 and a lot of these cars became like, that Audi R8 looks like a fucking TT to me, you know? So this is what I don't get is like, how do designs get worse over time, right? Look at the McLaren F1. That design has not been beat. That's from the 90s, right? Fastest car in the 90s or some shit. What else? I'm not a fan of the Murcielago, but in profile, right, just through the profile, I think it's the most beautiful car ever made. With the scissor door is sick in profile, but then Aventador is really sick. Yeah, over time cars got really watered down, and then what watered down cars the most is, I have to say, Tesla. Since Tesla came out, I thought to myself, does not look futuristic, does not look... I've never seen a Tesla that blew me away. And dude, my standards are pretty low. I've seen Acuras, those sedans. I don't know anything about Acura. I've seen Acuras that I liked, but I cannot get into Teslas. at all. And yeah, I like the Cybertruck. That's it. And I still haven't seen that. Like, it's not even coming out. But yeah, I used to be a car guy somewhat. And then it just, I think the last beautiful car that I would obsess over is the RX-8 with the wheel slide kit from Tokyo Drift. And I was thinking to myself, in the future, they got to make something cooler than this fucking old Tokyo Drift tuner. And no, no, nothing ever came out that was prettier than that car, in my opinion. Nothing ever came out. What else? I love the Supra. Nothing ever beat that Supra. I forgot, that was like early 2000s, right? Yeah, I just don't like cars anymore. I love toys. Don't get me wrong. You give me 10 mil, I'd love to have some toys. But I don't know what I'm into now. Like, what's my favorite car now? I don't know. Yeah, because do you remember the SLS AMG came out? At first, I was like, you know, that aggressive American look on a German vehicle is just retarded. In hindsight, the SLS AMG is the most beautiful car on earth, right? And that's why it became like this rare thing, because, dude, Mercedes never did it after that, right? That was fucking an awesome car for the big boy cars, right? But, yeah, like, I don't see any cars that I like anymore. Like, what do I like? Everyone just has Teslas now. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. You know? Ferrari's always been based, though. I'm not going to lie. Like, I remember when the 458 came out, I'm like, they're not going to beat a sexier design, right? It's just streamlined. It's perfect. It's the balance of what a toy should look like, right? And oh my god, 458 is dated, dude. The 488 looked better, and then the F8, holy shit, Ferrari knows what they're doing. But I still like the older Ferraris, the F, was it the F430? Yeah, if we're talking about design, I mean, the greatest design is, I'm not even gonna give it to Ferrari because it's not Italian. Yeah, Ferraris are Italian, but the greatest Ferrari design is from a Japanese man, and it's the Enzo, right? The Ferrari Enzo, which is such a stupid name. I like Enzo, but it's a stupid name. If we're gonna name it after the founder. No, that's stupid. We have the F40, most beautiful Ferrari ever. F50, people like it, I don't. The next one should have been the F60, not the fucking Enzo. So they botched the name, but when I look at designs, who really thinks LaFerrari looks better than the Enzo? Nobody. You're lying to yourself, bro. You're lying hard. So yeah, I don't know. I don't know if it's like, there's nothing more watered down than cars. You know, now they all look like, every Audi looks the same and every Tesla looks the same and they all look the fucking same. So it's weird, you know? Which I'm worried I'm becoming a boring person because now I'm thinking of just the Raptor. I'm like, ooh, fun. Let's just go for fun. The Raptor seems fun, right? Just a big old truck. But yeah, Enzo peaked aesthetics, right? I remember someone was trying to debate me that the Reventon, or it's Reben, right? With a V, but you pronounce it like that. He's trying to say that was sexier than the Enzo. And I'm like, what the fuck? I still love GTRs, right? Every time I see a GTR, I'm pretty happy. I don't know. I get a Jeep. My older brother has a Jeep. And I don't know if I'll be like a Jeep, because Jeep's not giving you space. At least, you know, I'm pretty big. I need space. Paganis are ugly. What the fuck are you talking about? The NSX, just overpriced, but it was gorgeous, yeah. Yeah. Nah, they need to make more of the old style with the lights, with the eyes closed. You know, the lights were completely down. I love that. Remember the Diablo? What Lambo beat that look? Nothing. Don't say Countach. Countach looks like shit. Looks like cardboard. Yeah, dude. I didn't realize like these 90s iconic supercars or hypercars, whatever the fuck they are now, I didn't realize that they're never gonna be beat, right? Like, who the fuck gets excited for a LaFerrari? Not me. But my taste has changed, you know. As a when I was younger, I hated Rolls-Royce, and now I think the Phantom is the most beautiful car on the road, right? A lot of people don't like that take, but it's not just distinct, it's striking. You know, there's no that when you think of the word striking features, it is the Phantom, without a doubt, right? Timeless. That I love it. But what else? It's just lame that it's luxury, you know? If you want to have fun, you go sport and have fun. Luxury is old man shit. You'll have enough time for that when you guys are champs. The F1 is, yeah, that McLaren. Besides sitting in the middle, which is kind of retarded. And my buddy Mo Reza would be like, why? You can get head from one girl and then the other girl because they sit next to you. And I'm like, what? The last thing I'd do if I had an F1 is be in there with people. I'd be alone. That'd be, you know. That's my favorite thing about streaming is you're alone, but live with people. Yeah, dude, I don't know. Now all I see is Teslas everywhere. And I'm like, ooh, this is hard. I wish I liked Tesla so I'd get excited when I see one. But when Teslas were new, I said to myself, what am I supposed to like, right? I know it's not known for its interior, it's trash, but the exterior of Teslas kind of looks like, are you sure that's the future? That's the future? Tesla should have gone with some concept car looks. Something, dude, and I know why Tesla's generic. They want to sell to everyone. They just want to like, bro, this lighting makes you look so good. What are you talking about? I look better with the ring light. I'm just a good looking guy, dude. Like, every time I'm at the gym, girls are staring at me and I'm like, yo, stop it. Stop it. What's it like being a human that doesn't get stared at by girls? Right? I know, because I was a kid once and I used to be like a loser. So I'm like, damn. People have that life as adults. That's just sad, right? The best part of my day is some dude gripping his girl at the gym tight because she's staring at me and I'm like, she's ugly, bro. Let her go. I'm not gonna take her, don't worry. You know what I mean? You got that primate build? Yeah, I do. I have angular striking features, you know. I spent a lot of my life not liking the mirror, and now I'm just doing whatever I can to remain looking like this. I'm like, don't age. This is good. Stay here. You know what I mean? Stay beautiful. No, I'm not getting gas. Fuck that shit. I'm the kind of guy that waits till it's like, bing, bing, bing. I live my whole life on 8% battery too. Like, I'm always low on everything. I don't know what it is. I hate that about me, but also everyone who has a full battery around me, I always make fun of them in my head. You know, if you come out with me and your battery's at 100%, there's something about that that makes me think like, what a fucking loser, you know? No, bro, I ain't smoking, bro. Not smoking ages people, you know. Smoking is disgusting. Let's check percentage. Oof, 3%. Wait, if I just went and got my charger and went live, do you guys want to just do all night IRL? I don't know if I want to be in front of a PC. I could talk all day, bro. I got loads of caffeine right now. These prices, they're World War III type shit. You know why they're promoting Top Gun? It's the timing of Top Gun is to radicalize the American people for a world war. So you got to remember, media is top down, right? They time everything perfect. Trust me on this. You think, oh, it takes a long time to make a movie. No, dude. No. They're priming Americans. Look at every single war the U.S. has been. Look at all the war movies that came out before Desert Storm. That's a coincidence, right? Give me a break. Give me a break. Should we do IRL today, or what do you want, guys? Or home? Well, IRL means me in a car driving around and grabbing Slurpees and shit. Oh, this thing's pretty beast. IRL means like this, dude. Like, I'm not trying to do 12 or 1 a.m. stream, bro. Now, that's one thing I've always loved is homeless people have always approached me and no one else on the street. And I've gotten that ever since I used to work security. And I'm like, I'm glad. I don't want to be like these people that don't get approached by homeless people. I like to be relatable, you know? I still remember there's a 7-Eleven down here, and dude, I would go every stream. We were getting like $30,000 of donations in a few weeks, and I'll go with heaps of cash, middle of the night to 7-Eleven and start fucking making it rain. Like, not actually making it rain, but I would give so much money away, I would tell no one about it. Right? And then I go stream and I was making even more. And I'm like, wow, look at this. I felt like Santa Claus. And now I can't afford a cheeseburger, dude. These stream analytics, this 500 viewer Andy, get the fuck out of here, bro. Do Gamba trains? No, dude. All I do is have a steak dinner with Train and tell him why I'm not crazy. You know what I mean? That's all I do. I'm like, this is why I'm not crazy, bro. What's the most you've been? What? Oh, that I pay back. What's the most money you've given someone and never gotten paid back for? Look, dude, let me tell you something before my battery dies. I've never asked for my money back, ever in my life. You know, anyone I've given large amounts of money to, I've always just never talked to them again because I knew they needed and shit. And I knew I'm like hustle mindset. I'm like, I'll make more. But I've never asked for it back. So, but I'd never, you know, like our friendship would end there. You know, I don't think we'd chill ever again because, yeah. But I don't know. Don't hand money to people. They're not going to pay you back. That's the moral of the story, bro. okay. Unless they're in trouble, but yeah. It's just weird collecting from your homie that owes you, you know? You feel like, yeah, this guy's life sucks. Like, fuck it. You know? A couple bands, keep it, bro. Fuck it. Just don't ask me again. Not true. Bro, I could call a bunch of people right now and I could collect right now. I've helped out too many friends. And it only took one of my friends to say, you're helping people because your friends are lowlifes. You should stop chilling with them. And I'm like, yeah. Yeah. Like, if your buddies are always in trouble, you need new buddies, dude. You know, they're always in trouble for a reason. You know, I get trouble, but always trouble? Get the fuck out of here. I got that from my dad. My dad would give so much money away, and people would never pay him back. And my dad would be like, don't worry, son. These people just, they can't do it. So just forget about it. Don't lend, though. Don't lend. Nobody's going to pay you back. Like, you know. I was also a drug dealer back then. Lol. I'm not in line. I'm in a parking lot, dude. When this phone dies, what should I do? Go to the PC or go grab the charger? It might take 20 minutes. But I drive fast when I'm offline. Wink. Most money you made in a month? When I was drug dealing, I made the most money. Streaming's way more, but I don't count streaming. Most I've ever made streaming in a month was like 70, 80 bands or something fucking outrageous. It was outrageous because I wasn't really innovative. I was kind of just farming VIPs or reacting. You know, it was kind of like making money laughing. You know, it didn't feel like work. So to me, that felt like billions of dollars. You know, it wasn't, imagine making that much stress-free. You know what I mean? Imagine if you're stressed and making that much, but that was a stress-free month. So to me, that was like, whoa. Roid rage. You need to start saving money. Oh, I've saved heaps. You know, I'm really good saving, dude. I didn't date a girl for years. I didn't go out with friends. Like, the whole time I'm on Twitch, I saved. And then I turned 28 and I'm like, whoa, I'm getting old. Like, I need to start traveling. I need to do some shit that I'm not going to do when I, you know, you can't travel when you're 40 at the same energy level. So I'm like, okay, burn a bit here. It's a write-off. Fuck it. And yeah, so now I'm kind of panicking in Mexico and Hawaii and shit, but only for a year. And then next year will be different. And then, yeah. But yeah, I'm big on saving. I just didn't think COVID would rob me 2 years. I thought I had 2 years to save. And then I realized, I'm like, oof, do I want to be traveling when I'm like 30? Nah. Okay, 1% battery, boys. Should we IRL or a PC? What do you want? I could get us live in 15 minutes if I'm fast. I could just grab a charger. My buddy's right here. I could just grab his charger. Wait, I could just go into that gas station and get a charger, right? No! What am I doing at 1%? What the fuck, bro? What am I doing, bro? This is a gas station. Wait here. Fuck. Come with me. Fuck. Fucking idiots. Sell me that Metabot. Thanks. Y'all got iPhone chargers? Okay. iPhone charger? Is this it? Takes so long to hydrate for me, man.
paper. Fuck.
Okay, are we back? What was I saying? Yeah, New Halo sucked, the TV show. Spray painting, artwork. I mean, it's better than me painting. I always sucked at that. I need something to make me less rage-filled. Like, what do you guys do? You guys always say gaming, but I can't find a game I get into. There's no game that's good that you can casually play. The good games, you get angry when people fucking no scope you, so it's like I need less anger, so I can't just game, you know? Is that the thumbnail? Just do shrooms? Dude, you know when I try shrooms is when I'm 60 years old and I'm like, I've done everything I need to do. Because you guys a lot of the time say, oh, but this guy did shrooms. Name one person who did shrooms that I want to be like them, right? Like my heroes, Martin Shkreli. Hey, he's out of prison, by the way. That's my favorite Albanian man. That's the true 4chan. Mike Tyson. I don't want to be like Mike Tyson. As much as I like him, listen to him, and when he's based, it's hella based, but when he's not, it's like a hit or miss for me. But I don't think I want to live like Tyson. He's clouded. You know what I mean by that? Like, he's always hot. He's always clouded. And it's not a good thing. Sometimes I question Wiz Khalifa's work ethic. I'm like, whatever happened to Wiz? And it's because he smokes too much, you know? Like either weed or shrooms, but those things kill your soul eventually, right? A bit of weed is fun, a little bit. Or for me, a lot, because I don't get high. All my life, I said this last stream, I think. All my life, when I smoke up, I'm like, damn, that's a lot of anxiety when I smoke. Now, I smoke to get anxiety, you know? Like, when I was a teenager, when I was like 18, 19, I'd smoke and I'd be like, oh, this is too much. And now I'm looking for that anxiety, you know, that scared feeling, and I never get it. And you know what I mean by this? Yeah. Like, I don't normally smoke just to have fun. Like, when I smoke, you know, I haven't smoked in months, but this week I think I'm gonna have a session just to have a funny ass stream and shit. But I'm gonna get blasted on stream. Like, something like this. Wait, how's it work? Can I smoke up my own car if it's parked somewhere? And I get out of the car and I go do shit and I never go back to the car? Is that allowed? How's this work on Twitch? I've met productive people who smoke a lot of weed, and I'm like, how, bro? How do you do that? How the fuck are you doing that, bro? Weed and video games. Man, I remember when I was into Battlefield 3 2012 or whatever, or 2011, and I was having a snipe off with some dude from the other side of the map, and it was a squad. I think it was squad or team deathmatch. I never played Conquest, which only makes sense on a PC with all those players. And I was high as fuck, smoking up and playing. And I shot, missed, he shot, missed, I shot, missed, he shot, boom, he hit me. As soon as he hit me, I'm at 1% HP or some shit. And my nose exploded, started bleeding as soon as I got hit. And I stopped smoking weed for like half a year because of that, because of the anxiety I got from that like experience. And my buddies and I used to do this thing that's so fucking embarrassing. We would max out the speakers of the TV so one gunshot shakes the house. It's so loud. And I said to them, I'm like, we can feel like we're actually at war if we smoke weed and play on max volume. And I convinced my buddies, I had like a few buddies, and that's how we'd play. And looking back, I'm like, damn, I'd get a headache if I did that now. But in crazy blazing firefights, you would shit your pants if you're high, right? And you'd think we'd be laughing like, oh, how loud it is. We were all dead serious, like we're at war. And I'm like, man, I always did extreme shit to have fun. You know what I mean? I always did weird shit. I remember before YouTube prank channels, I would drive around Carisdale neighborhood. It's a rich old white neighborhood. And I'd blast porn on the aux cable of my car. I just got my driver's license at like 17. And I'd drive around terrorizing this town. Oh, yes, fuck me. Like loud ass porn, vocal. And I did that before YouTubers even did that. And I didn't even do it for YouTube. I did it so me and my two buddies could laugh and have fun. And we would be red in the face, so embarrassed when people stared at us doing that. And one lady looked at me like this, and I'm like, I hate Nicki Minaj. And my buddy said, you are the funniest guy we've ever met in our life. Like, because you know how Nicki Minaj songs have like some of those moaning sound bites? Yeah, looking back, I used to do a lot of extra shit to get my rocks off. I remember when I became a kleptomaniac in malls, and I wouldn't even keep the items I stole. I would give them away to my homie or my brother. And it was so strange because it was like, I would live for the beeper to go off so I can start running. And it started off like as a pussy, and then I got better and better at it. And became like one of the most addicted. You want this spot?
No, it'll be loud.
Oh, it's fine, yeah. I'm talking to my ex-wife, so I don't care. And basically it was like, back then I was like a completely, I needed to feel something type guy. You know what I mean? I needed to feel something. And I stopped doing it around 19 because I'm like getting a little old for stealing and shit. But it was the most addictive shit I've ever been into, is stealing in malls and letting the alarm go off and having my heart race. And sometimes no one would even care. Like, they just let me run with it. But other times I'd be chased. And I still remember, I know I'm going to hell because of this incident. I was with Blin and E. And this story is so toxic, but I'm gonna try and say it in a like responsible 28-year-old man way. All right, I gotta stop thinking like a 15-year-old. You want this story? It's like a stealing story in a Walmart. It's really toxic. Like, there's no higher level of toxic. This is worse than racism. This is the highest level of toxic. Okay. One time, my buddy and my best friend, we went to a mall, and these guys were like pussy jackers. They wouldn't steal shit. They'd rely on me, and I've never been materialistic. I try to, like, I try, oh, get a nice watch, but, you know, I can't do it. You know, I need experiences, you know. That's why I like traveling. Anyways, so I brought a backpack to Walmart, and I stole, I think, $1,000 worth of stuff. And I looked good in high school because I was stealing, like, $100 packs of Crest white strips. So my teeth were glowing white. Electronics, all sorts of shit. Expensive shit, right? Not no Mickey Mouse type shit. So anyways, we go to this Walmart, I fill up my backpack, and we go to the clerk to pay, right? You know how they have those aisles? This is before automation. Yang gang, what's up? People would scan their items, right? And my backpack's full, but I'm gonna buy some stuff to look ordinary, right? The toothpaste, yeah, good one. So anyways, the clerk there, he didn't seem suspicious at all. Just a bunch of teenagers, three teenagers, and whatever. He scans the items, and, you know, we're off. You know, we're pretty much on our merry way. We're like, okay, we bought the, you know, $20 worth of stuff. My backpack is filled with $800 worth of stolen items. And this was not a regular klepto. This is like my peak of my career. And you gotta understand, I come from a really straight edge family. They don't even jaywalk. So I'm the only different one, right? I think the insecurity came because I was like an underachiever. I was like a high level gamer, but my parents didn't care about that. They didn't care about my Dragon Knight, highest level, best guild, all that, pro. But they didn't care about that. They only cared about grades. So I was kind of like the loser. I'm like, yo, I gotta be good at something. I'm good at stealing shit, fuck it, you know? And I would get so good that I would steal just for the sport of it. So I would go up to the counter, I'd be like, no, give me the other pack of gum over there. And the guy would give me the gum, and I'd be like, strawberry? And he'd be like, oh yeah, let me get you strawberry. And he'd grab the mint gum off my hand, turn his back to me to switch it for strawberry, and I'll just boom, grab whatever's in the front counter, boom, in my pocket, and I go, yeah, that's the one. So every single time I said, can you grab me that behind you, I would steal something, and my buddies would be like, yo, he's quick, this guy is. I didn't even like what I'm stealing. I'm just showing my buddies how good I got after a year. Anyways, we're at Walmart, and the clerk, there's no easy way to say this, because I really, really, you know, like, I don't like this story at all. Like, this is like the most toxic story I could tell, because it's funny but really toxic. The clerk had Down syndrome, and he checked on my $20 items, and he said, have a good day. And, you know, that left a, you know, weird feeling in my stomach. But broke kid, I want my items, I'm gonna get it one way or another. I leave Walmart. I was a big communist, hated corporations, still do, but not a commie. Anyways, so I go, and then it goes beep, 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 plus there's stairs with security at the bottom. So this isn't, come on, bro, this isn't something where you can just run, because there's security at the bottom and a whole stairs you gotta go to leave the Walmart. So I said, I looked at my buddies when it started beeping, and, you know, my heart falls through my asshole, my face goes white, right? And I was pale as a ghost. I was like, I need to play my white privilege card now. And my tan disappeared. I was like white as a ghost. And I panicked, and I said, I can't run. My buddy's like, don't you dare, you know, because this is not one of those run situations. There's a lot of Walmart still left to leave. So the handicapped guy goes like this to me, young guy. I walk back. He looked at all my items. He said, yeah, they're all checked. In your bag, he pointed. And I gave him my bag because I knew this is it. My career is over. He unzipped the bag in front of everyone, pulled all the items on the table. And me and my two buddies are like really about to puke. We're like, we're caught. Here comes security and everything. And he scanned all the items. He's like, oh, my bad. Beep, 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 beep. Have a nice day. And I'm frozen. I'm looking at him like, huh? And my buddy nudges me like, let's go. And I'm like, oh, shit. And we put him back in the bag because he must have thought we put the items back in the bag or something. And he just didn't scan it right. And I don't know how that even makes sense, but we left with all the items scanned and it didn't beep. And it was like the most bittersweet, funny, but also kind of sad feeling we've ever had. Taking the bus home, we felt like absolute monsters. And this is the ending of my klepto career. But I'll never forget his face and how he did it with a smile. And there's nothing sinister. Like, he genuinely thought we paid for it and it just didn't scan correct. And young guy, he's like 22 or, right? Yeah, that's the first time I'm like, I'm going to hell, man, you know? A W cashier, yeah. Pretty crazy. Like, if you had the images in my head, you'd be crying. Because it's like the biggest shame. You know, I think I'd rather have been caught now that I look back. Because that story is just too much, man. It doesn't sound like much unless you can see what I'm seeing in my head. Very great, humble, nice kid. And yeah. I was once down on my luck and I tried. I'm like, you know, I had no thrills. I tried stealing as an adult. I think I was like 22, 21. And the alarm went, and I'm not gonna run as an adult. That just looks weird. And I looked at the cashiers, and I just did this, as in like, come and get me. And I just walked out. And I was 23, I think. Pretty recent now that I think about it. But I never stole after that because I felt so slimy. Like, everyone in that store looked at me like the 6'5 tattoo guy. That's who you're gonna go confront. And my buddies are like, dude, you could just keep stealing shit and walking out. Who's really gonna confront you? You look like a crackhead. Like, you look really, really terrifying. Like, nobody's gonna be, you know, it's not worth it to go for like $100, whatever. And I was like, whoa, you know, like, as a teenager, it was a different feeling, but stealing as an adult is like a weak feeling. And I was like, man, I'm broke. I'm gonna do some desperate people shit. And I got good at doing desperate people shit, not stealing, but other stuff. Made some coin, and then I was like, damn, there's no like, yeah, I remember the first time I made $8,000 on one drug deal. And imagine cash. And it was like 6 band profit. And what a feeling, dude. You know, if you've never had shit and then you've done that, and I was working 3 jobs. So it was like, it was the cherry on top. But fast money comes with real problems, man. That's why you shouldn't make an OnlyFans. That's why I don't have an OnlyFans, right? You know what I mean? In a video game? No, dude, I used to really drug deal heavy. Like, uh, Yeah, like I used to be really good at it. By good at it, I mean I've never done small little amounts. Like I was moving large amounts, right? And didn't have too many problems with no tweaker, nothing like that. Good clientele. Yeah, honest living, dude. And honest living means peace of mind, you know? Because I realized something. I'm like, one thing nobody understands about the dollar is that if it comes with a overwhelming amount of stress, then how is it money? You know, money's supposed to better your life. You know what I mean by that? So that's why I'm like, you know, a lot of these paths are not worth it. But yeah, I've tried a lot of these things, you know? Yeah. I've tried a lot of ways that are like, in hindsight. This is like 4 or 5 years. No slap on the wrist shit. This is like 4 or 5 years, your first time. And people are like, I got some hard asses in my Discord like, Zirka, 5 years in prison. That's not that bad. Yeah, it is when you're in your 20s. Your 20s? 5 years of your 20s? Are you retarded? I still remember the first time I said I'm never fucking drug dealing is this fucking hand tattoo, right? The first week I got this hand tattoo, I'm driving like this and I get pulled over and searched, and I was clean, completely clean. You know, I never fucked around and did stupid shit. Like when I was, most of the time I was driving super clean, right? I would see it as a job. You know how like drug dealers always got shit on them? I was appointment or nothing. And when I got pulled over for a hand tattoo, I was like, whoa, that was traumatizing. I didn't know you could get pulled over for nothing. And I'm like, damn, if that was a Sunday, or you know, if that was a Saturday or Sunday, that would have been it for me, right? Because that's not no little bag here and there. That's like 5 years. But yeah. Yeah, I always done extreme shit though, you know? I remember when I said, dude, I was like to my buddies, I was like, yo, look how much I made, da da da. And they're like, yeah, you don't spend, so like this shit's for you. Like you're not fucking retarded. And so I was like stacking it up and shit. And I realized I'm too fucking weird, because there's this tailored by the Richmond Center with this Polish guy. Everyone knows him, this old guy, right? He has a Bible on the table and he tailored suits and stuff. And I would just every week send all my nice clothes, all my nice underwear, every piece of fabric. I still have a lot of it in my house. Had a stitched pocket. He would do stitch pockets in my underwear. He would do stitch pockets in the back of my coat, the middle of the coat, right? Right? And the pockets that I designed, right? I felt like Kanye with clothing. I would design the pockets like this, right? I'd throw him $100. This is like a $10 thing. I throw him $100 so he listens, right? And I'm gonna use one guy because he knows what the fuck I'm doing. And I'll design the pockets like this, right? You know how pockets like this? I'll design it like this. So I grab my fucking blazers or whatever jacket I got, and I'll shake it to see if drugs would come out, right? Or if I'm in a fight or something, it wouldn't fall out, and it wouldn't fall out and stuff. And I was like thinking of how can I get a zipper that's not metal? And I was doing so much extra shit, but that's, I swear to God, that shit helped me the most, right? A lot of my buddies would get their shoelaces tied to their bag, right? Their bag of shit, and it would be hovering on their crotch, which, you know, I've done pat downs. That's the first thing you'll feel. But if it's a strategic pocket in the underwear, and I was like, I would sit at, you know, like how I'd sit to be a better gamer or bodybuilder or streamer or bouncer or whatever, I'd sit at home to like be the ultimate drug dealer. I'm like, what can I do to be better? How can I be better than people? Like, right? And my buddies would make fun of me because this is like little shit, but little shit made all the fucking difference, right? the smartest thing I ever did. Not just, I would do trips to Kelowna, I would do trips to Burnaby, always in a suit and tie, and I'd never get pulled over. When my buddy saw me in a suit and tie, imagine seeing a bouncer dressed in a suit and tie in a blazing hot summer. It made no sense. Suspenders, right? And I would always meet the cops. If there was like a roadblock, I'd be like, what's this? And the cops would be like, you know, I wouldn't wait for them to come to me. I'd go to them. And they never suspect shit. Suit and tie, clean shaven, da da da. I was obsessed with optics. I'm like, I'll never get pulled over. They'll never call me. Right now, I look dirty, right? But imagine a suit and tie and clean shaven and shit. And I learned that from this dude in VIP section who, man, he gave me the best advice, right? I'm like, how'd you go to the top of this? And this guy would sell this thing called cocaine. And I'm like, how the fuck is everyone else in trouble? They either get jump killed or they get, you know, they get locked up. I'm like, how the fuck have you been doing this for this long, right? What separates you from everyone else, right? And this guy had Ferraris and everything. And he leaned over in the middle of the club. I'll never forget what he said. And he's like this to me. The difference from me and every other coke dealer in this city, John, I don't do coke. And I was like, what? He's like, never tried it, never will. And I was like, what do you mean? You're like always around. You touch it with your finger, you get high, bro. This shit is like, you know what I mean? That's, nope. He'd outsource people do shit for him. He was like the mastermind and shit. And I'm like, why? And he's like, everyone's downfall is when they're high. And I was like, whoa, right? And he lost his older brother like that. And he's like, oh, he was like super big on if you're gonna be selling drugs, be sober all the time. You'd have drinks, but that's about it. And so I'd like learn from this guy and shit. And but now, you know, I'm not gonna say what I was. At one point I was a pharmacy. I was selling shit that people don't even know what it is, but the rich people would use it. Yeah, I was like, I'd spend all day just researching on different compounds and shit like that. And this, why it's so shocking to me, like the way I see this is like, that was like a university for me, is I lived a very clean lifestyle. High school, like, I didn't do drugs until I was 22 or 21, or really late. All my buddies did at like 15 or whatever, right? So I was like really late to the party, but it's just because I want to honor my parents. I was like, you know, you can't do drugs when you're like, Mom, Dad, what's for dinner? But yeah, and yeah, now that I think about it, I'm like, dude, what a strange world, you know? Like, that is such a strange world. Knives to my throat, you know? A lot of fuck shit that happened to me, you know what I mean? And I can't believe that was the norm. That's why I say being broke will make you desperate and act like a fucking fool. Gotta get it together. Holy shit. Yeah. Yeah. Someday I want to be a Giga Chad like you. Bro, Chad life starts, one, with not giving a fuck. That's one. My bad, bro. This guy looking at me crazy. What's up? And number two, humble yourself, young Padawan. Another thing, you gotta always be ready for a fight, bro. A scrap blood. You heard? Right? This is what you do anytime someone tries to fight you. You go, no, 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 I don't want to fight you because I would hurt you. And then they'd be like, whoa. Whoa. No, 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 I don't want to fight you because I would hurt you. Say it in that tone. My guy, no, wants to fight you. Raiders are trash. Bro, let me tell you something, dude. Let me tell you something. That hurt me. Like, I'm gonna go to bed thinking of that. Oh, shit! Why is it at 1% battery, bro? What the fuck? Hold up. As long as it's in park, we're good. We're at 1% battery, so dude, streaming doesn't charge it up, I guess. Because it's streaming. Should I just go home? Tips for bouncers? Don't do that job, dude. Right? That job is not good, dude. Why does your blue pill voice sound so natural? It's the real me. I drop my voice when I'm streaming, bro. Hold up. Okay, as long as we're in park, we can chill with electricity and... yeah. Bottle looks tiny. What bottle? Oh, bro, I was thinking whiskey. What are you talking about? This bottle? Yeah, my hands are pretty big. This is what women like the most, is holding a giant hand. And as soon as you feel her hand and she goes, wow, his hand's so big, you remind yourself that she cannot do better than you. So she is in debt to you. But if you have the same size hand as your girl, that's not okay. You need hand implants. How come women are allowed to get implants, but we men have to stay the same forever, bro? Like, I want some titty implants, bro. Don't get me started on women, dude. Yeah, this bottle's... look, my head's big too. I used to think, is it good to have a big head? Dude, if you have a big head, this is good for a street fight. Small heads, not good. Harder target, but a weaker target. Look at the best MMA fighters. They have heads bigger than Majora's Mask. Nah, bro, I used to think women are selectors and stuff, but when you look at a high value man, like, let's be honest, the male peacock is prettier. So this is me. That's just my spirit animal. I'm the selector, you hear? Little Steve, remember when Destiny got mad that I said, why? I don't fuck with short people. He's like, why? I'm like, they need to choose better loadouts. And they did a whole subreddit saying,
John is insecure because he like loves to make these jokes where he talks about choosing the wrong loadout. And it's like the most short man thing I've ever read. Right? Short people come in two forms. One, the one I like, the ones who know their place. Right? They walk around like, I'm short, whatever. And then two, the ones who they're called dreamers. Right? They Google, like, how do I get taller? No, bro. If you're short, it means you're close to hell, right? The underworld. It means you're satanic. It means you are of the devil. Tall people are close to the heavens, close to the vibration of God. If you're a flat earther, this really hurts. You see that photo I posted on Twitter? I'll be spamming Twitter and then deleting the post after spam just so someone sees it. One motherfucker saw it. I know they did. It was a photo of Mars and on the landscape, there's a hole that looks like a door. And one fucking boomer wrote, are we sending a rover to with a high quality camera to investigate what's inside the door? And I messaged the dude, I'm like, probably not. This is my favorite thing of these NASA and SpaceX scams. They'll be like, we found a door on Mars, but we're not getting closer. Oh, we found a pyramid on the moon, but we're not gonna investigate further. And it's like, at what point you have to say to yourself, like, wait a minute, it's been years. Are they just not interested, or is this just a scam? There's a door on Mars. That's it. Period. End of story. It's over. Next, we're gonna see a chair from far away, a blurry Bigfoot sighting chair. That's it. It's over. My favorite was that, man, we still have that VOD up, which if you haven't seen me debate the doctor, you've missed out on the best content we've had ever. And then her 144 IQ brother came in to get destroyed in that debate. Her chat exploded laughing when he's like, you ever been on a plane? And my chat's like, you don't want to do that, dude. That is a no-go zone. But, yeah, it always baffles me how much of a scam Mars is. Elon Musk posted on Twitter. He said, something about SJWs will be the reason why we don't make it to Mars. Dude, you know me, I would love to blame them. But, wow. Some of you guys are so far gone. Oh, I'm a super flat earther, dude. I'll debate anyone tonight. I'll debate anyone. Just don't come with math models. It gets so, the debate gets so boring with math models. Someone said in chat, we will see humans die on Mars in our lifetime. And yeah, I do have 20/20 vision. I see it from here. Dude, let me tell you something, man. If you believe we're going to Mars, you really got to ask the question of why we didn't go back to the moon. At this point, it should be easy, right? But, oh, there's nothing there, John. Well, do your little marketing campaign for Tesla then with SpaceX. Put a Tesla on the moon. I mean, guys, you believe in computer-generated images of Mars. I would, you know, if my tax dollars went to that, I was an American, that would sting. I'm not an American. I pay for the Canadian arm. We destroyed the technology and it's a painful process to build it back up. That's what the astronaut said. They destroyed the technology to go to the moon and they're just too lazy. My favorite is when they said they lost all the telemetry data of the moon landing. And I'm like, this is not my cousin's bar mitzvah, bro. This is the moon landing. You saying you lost the footage? The greatest clip I want to react to today is I keep bringing weapons of mass destruction into debates this week and arguments. And just this week, just yesterday or today, I forgot, Bush fumble? He kind of, I guess I'll save it, I'll show you guys. But he kind of, he leaked his war crimes. And the NPCs just laughed. They laughed like a million dead Iraqis was funny to them or something. Ain't that sick? I genuinely, in my heart, believe civilians don't give a fuck about Iraqis. Bro, the Iraqi people have gotten the least sympathy out of any tribe on earth. Could you imagine if the U.S. accidentally invaded Ukraine and killed a million of them? Dude, there would be like reparations and all this shit. Hey, I genuinely think most humans, every single color in the US, every single race, don't give a fuck about Iraqis, right? They just don't, right? Canadians, Americans, nobody even talks about Desert Storm. Nobody cares. And I'm like, how can you admit, oh, what the fuck? This is a Maybach. What the fuck? A Maybach SUV. This city, gnarly, bro.
It's pretty crazy, right?
Yeah. Oh, look, he got happy in looking his car. I hate when the Maybach has the Mercedes-Benz logo, though. It's kind of like, no, do your own thing. And the Maybach has always been ugly to me. But I've never seen that. Look at that. Kind of looks like a Benz. It's kind of stupid looking. Kind of dated looking. Address leak. Bro, like I give a fuck, bro. Like, I'm at this gas station. What are you gonna do, bro? Are you gonna bring your Valorant skills and beat me up? Like, shut the fuck up. Bro, I have $4,000 cash if you're trying to rob me, bro. Okay? You won't do shit. You know why? I'll tell you why. Because you guys say I move like I'm 170-pound crackhead. I move like a crackhead. I'm high energy, right? I weighed myself on the stream today. 257 pounds. You don't want to get punched by me. I'll move that shit like it's 500 pounds, dude. I will move my arms fast. I haven't weighed myself in so long. When I saw that weight, and you guys been calling me skinny, and oh, you lost weight and shit. Maybe appearance, but dude, that is gnarly amount of weight I'm carrying. Like, when I have so many tall friends who are really close to 210, and I'm thinking like, dude, where do I hide all this weight, man? That's crazy. I wish I kind of grew up in the U.S. sometimes, so I'd get into football, right? I think I'd have loved football. You need a wingman that's a short king. Good optics for you, John. No, what the fuck? I go out with my tall buddies, bro. Bro, short people get extra sad. It's like kind of like annoying to be around.
You know what I mean? A lot of short guys get like, when, you know, if my tall friend gets sad, it's whatever, but he's not like about to cry. When a short guy gets sad, it's too much, bro. He'd be killing vibes. You know? You gotta stay around your people. Yeah. So I stay with, you know, I chill with Doc. Right? It's me and Dr. Disrespect. And everything I'm saying is a lie because the biggest soy boy is 6'4" and his name is Hassan. Right? So everything I'm saying is just, God, he just ruined the whole, yeah. If it wasn't for Hassan, everything I said would really hit, you know? All right. Let's see, battery. Oh, we just cruising at 1% battery? We're on park. As long as we're on park, that beeping will stop them. We're good. When we put on drive and we don't put our seatbelt on, the beeping goes, meaning you got to put your seatbelt on, safety, right? Safety first. Thoughts on Khan saying Asians have an improper diet for boxing? Did he say that? Look, I'm not gonna touch on that because not because it's a race thing, but it's a boxing thing, right? But also, when we look at longevity, don't Japanese people on that island, Okinawa or whatever, they live the longest, like they have the best diet? It's kind of like a pescatarian thing. Price of gas is $40 billion sent to Zelensky's credit card, bro. No American even cares. What the fuck? I saw these videos showing like homeless people in the US and I'm like, damn, even these videos are not enough to change Americans. You know what I mean? It's kind of crazy. But war is a racket, man. And you guys got to remember, when US says they're giving $40 billion in aid, what they're really telling you is they're making $1 billion in profit. Okay? I think the most interesting thing, the most interesting part of politics is, it's the one job where you can never guess how they're making their money. How did Nancy Pelosi accumulate over $100 million? That's not her salary. Nobody knows. Nancy don't even know. Politics is banditos shifting slush funds. That's it. Crazy world, dude. Canelo switched to vegan diet and got destroyed. Yeah, no, we've seen that for performance, you need a bit of meat. Yeah, we've seen that time and time again. No doubt. No doubt. The one thing about the one thing you should understand about meat is it does age you faster. And a lot of fitness guys love to lie and say, no, John, I look young and high protein diet got me a six pack and it makes me look young. And that's not what I'm saying at all, dude. Of course, when you're young, you're going to look tight. You know, it's muscle sparing. You know, you're going to look good on it. But digesting meat over decades and decades, it does age you faster, without a doubt. Right? I mean, if you want to look really good, it's a few handfuls of meat a week. It's not that much meat. I only do high protein for the appearance, but one day I'm gonna give it up. I know I am. You know, when I'm like 35, pretty sure I'm gonna be like a vegan with a few chicken meals a week. You know, something sustainable. Something to keep my energy levels correct, you know? Yeah. No, man. Dude, the problem with veganism is that they don't have meat in their diet, right? If you ever meet a... that's not a good sign. If you've ever met a vegan that incorporates... I know it sounds stupid, but a non-ethical vegan, like a healthy vegan, which they kind of like hard to find, but there are a few vegans on earth that have a few meat plate dishes of meat a week, right? And these are the healthiest people on earth, right? These are the healthiest people on earth, is vegan with a bit of meat when you're craving it. This is a good thing, right? You Americans got to get some fruits, bro. Fruits are king. But you know what? We said this last time. Google, if you have a second monitor right now, Google what a real banana looks like. There's no fleshy parts to the banana. It's all seeds and it looks decrepit. So sometimes I think, what the fuck am I eating? That yellow banana can't be that healthy. But it's a lot better than our regular canned Spam and McDonald's and our human meat food choices, bro. You know what I'm saying? Another thing. Check this out, dude. Another thing you should think about while we're on this fitness shit. If you drink Sprite and Coca-Cola and shit like this, right? The sugary drinks, not this one, but yeah, even this one. But I'm talking about the ones with calories, right? If you read the label, Americans drink 2 liters of syrup a day. You know what's making this tasty is syrup. There's syrup. So think of maple syrup, you know? I'm talking about the regular Coke. Dude, when you start seeing fizzy drinks and all the stuff you have as syrup, it's disgusting. It's syrup, dude. You're drinking syrup all day. That's not even close to water, right? Syrup. No wonder you fat as fuck, right? When the only time you're not eating, you're downing maple syrup, bro. Corn syrup, whatever the fuck. High fructose. That's disgusting. Nah, lemon water. That's the shit. I think I'd rather die than drink Dasani water in a video game. Have you tried Dasani? I've never had a bottle of Dasani where I said, thank God I have this bottle. I was so thirsty. That shit is disgusting, bro. I think Fiji water is my favorite. But yeah, when it comes to health, don't listen to me. I had like 5 cigarettes in this 1 hour stream. No, don't drink tap water. Do not, dude, tap water is disgusting. Ugh. I like a nice purified water. I used to love carbonated water, and then I looked at the sodium, and I was like, oh, whoa, what the fuck?
Smart water is okay. Creatine, man, I haven't had creatine in so long. I miss creatine. Creatine is very based. Yeah. Creatine is just like a gas tank, right? Scoop, you're done for the day, every day. And yeah, I need some creatine in my life. Yeah, if I could rate supplements, I would say the greatest physiques are built with, number one is pre-workout. Caffeine is a game changer. Caffeine is a performance enhancing drug. It's not a drug, but you know what I'm saying? It's psychoactive, it's amazing. So I'd say, you know, understand your what caffeine. I like Gorilla Mind, use code John, get 10% off for your workouts. Caffeine is number one. So pre-workout's the most important to changing your body. Second would be protein shakes, because protein shakes are game changers, right? Without protein shakes, you're gonna eat chips and stupid shit. Protein shakes are the greatest filler, the greatest, cucks your appetite, you don't cheat on your meals, none of that shit, right? And then third would be creatine. Actually, before creatine, a nice sleep supplement, you know, magnesium, zinc. You're getting good sleep, those workouts, you'll start crushing them. And then Anadrol is heavy, dude. Yeah. Don't forget fiber. Yeah, I used to have a fiber supplement. I forgot, I think it was like, I used to do it years ago. I think it was Metamucil or something. I don't believe in vitamins if you're in a caloric surplus. There's no point. Dieting, yeah, sure, I have your little Flintstones, bro. Fruits is great, yeah. Fruits for fitness is like one of the most underrated, because we watch so many bodybuilders and, you know, these guys have crazy genetics, so they can't just do fruits. But for the average guy, oh yeah. Yeah, Fousey looks great. I saw a picture of him. He looks like he's really working hard, hitting the gym, boxing, all that. Let's see this. Doesn't caffeine hinder your lifts because it constricts your blood vessels? So that's the biggest load of horse shit I've ever heard. Caffeine does not damage your lifts. Trust me, dude. If anything, you might hurt yourself. You might do too, you know, your workload might be too high, thinking you can do too much with, you cracked out on caffeine. All right, should we go home? Let's go home stream. Okay, tomorrow we'll do a full battery IRL. Yeah. Should we do it, not in the gym, where it's noisy shit, right when I'm done, we'll be boom. Maybe go shopping a bit too. Cheese steak with mushroom. No, bro, cut out. Bro, you want to cut dairy, dude. All right? All you dairy heads are retarded. Dairy is rocket fuel for cancer. Okay? You shouldn't be. Trust me, your little Subway sandwich, get no cheese on it. You won't really taste the difference that much. Yeah, start cutting out dairy, bro. Dairy fogs your mind too. You can't think straight on dairy, right? You know when you'll be the smartest is empty stomach and then fucking just steak. Because if you have potatoes with steak, you get a little foggy with carbs. But you just steak digesting alone, you're so sharp between your ears. Yeah, smoking gives you cancer too. Don't fuck that shit. I only smoke so I don't fucking rip my nails out and do crackhead shit. So I'm in pain, so. I love milk, though. Ew, what the fuck? Milk is disgusting. It's the most. I know grown men who drink chocolate milk. Like, what are you, a fucking retard? That's disgusting. Yeah, milk is cum. It's the cow's ejaculate. You don't want that in you. It's not, no, bro. When people say milk is a good source of protein, they're retarded. CBD, seems like a scam, dude, to be honest. I haven't researched it. A lot of, you can tell something's a scam if companies come and go a lot, right? Stuff that's legit is here to stay. Protein shakes, here to stay. Creatine, here to stay. A lot of, you know, a lot of shit that come into the market and leave and do weird shit. Yeah, that's shady. You want to add timeless truths to your life, whether traditional values or stuff that have been on the market for a long time. But John, what about a Rolex? Yeah, Rolex don't even depreciate, bro. So yeah, Rolex ain't a bad purchase, right? Your car is a worse idea than a Rolex, dude. Timeless. Everything you buy should be timeless. But the progressives are going to make you go into these fad diets and woke shit. Scammers. Well, if it's for cancer patients, then shouldn't you wait till you have an issue before starting? I don't know if that's true, though. CBD for cancer. I think I've heard of that. Yeah, no, you know what's funny? I read having aspirin often is healthy, right? So I always avoided that shit, but I'm like, oh yeah, that does make sense that you don't want, you know how they say like it'll thin the blood a bit or whatever? Yeah, you kind of want to go through most of your life with a couple aspirins in you. It's not like the worst thing in the world. So every now and then I'll pop some aspirins just for the fuck of it. But yeah, I'm down for the aspirin. I read some good shit about it. Anti-inflammatory, yeah. ECA stack. Oh, it's incredible. I haven't done it in years, but a little dangerous, but oh, it works on an empty stomach. That shit works. If you're cutting, that shit is, right? Even on a bulk, really, like, that is a good workout. Why I say it's a little dangerous for a lot of these things is because I know retards don't know what they're doing, you know? It's not that I'm a pussy. It's that I know what the average IQ is and how they're going to approach this shit. I'm not doing it to be the safety channel, right? I'm not the CDC, bro. Watch out for monkeypox. Did you guys get your vaccines for monkeypox yet? I just got mine in the back alley over here. There's a CDC building right here. Oh, leader Zirka never change. Hey, liked you. All right, let's go home. Okay, I'll be back in 20 minutes, 15 minutes. Dropping. I bet I can get someone to hit live right now and get you guys an intro quickly before I get there, because I'm logged in. I know I can. Jill POV. No, Jill's POV is this. This is what you see when we get.
Ha 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 ha!
I'm sorry for coming so fast. I'm sorry for coming so fast, Julian. I'm sorry for coming in 5 minutes.
No, I last a long, well, not the first time. The first time was kind of WTH and GO. WTH, pretty bad. Yeah, she's like, whoa, that was kind of quick. And I said to her, I'm like, you know, she was in my bio for a year. Right? So I'm like, you know, you were my crush. And she's like, no, I don't believe you. I'm like, no, why would I lie about that? You think I'm like manipulating? I'm not. And then I think girls should believe a guy if he busts quick the first time. Then he likes you. Because if he doesn't, that means he probably fapped before meeting you, which means he's nervous. So that's why he lasted longer. No, I didn't go for round two. I just adapted eventually. But now we do it too much. We need to chill and do more vacation stuff. We be like rabbits. This is the best girl I've ever owned. I mean, met. Yeah. Big ups to Jill. Jilly Bear. Like, sometimes I do phone calls with her like this, like how I'm talking to you guys. And it's the first time I've ever FaceTimed someone. And I'm like, I miss you. I miss you so much. And I start getting emotional.
It's crazy, right? If he ever says John is cold and insensitive, she's lying. I'm emotional. Offline, I'm the most emotional fucking dude I know. Don't listen. I don't know, bro. I went to the gym and I was like, I'm gonna get sweaty. I just wore this shirt. What do you want me to dress up for you, bro? It's laundry day again. I'm a Horus. That's my zodiac sign. Why are you asking that? Who the fuck is this guy? You get bullied here, dude. This feels like I'm drug dealing, bro. What are we doing in this parking lot? Let's get the fuck out of here. I'm gonna see you guys in 20 minutes. Music. Play me out to a song. Okay, still in park. Safe and
superstore and zero stores. What it boils down to for me.
Sorry.
Good. Yeah. Pull it right in the sky. So I'll let you out. Baby.
I'll see you guys in 20 minutes.